Bah.
Hold on.
Sleigh bells ring.
Oh my God! Hello.
Snow is glistening. A beautiful sight. We're happy tonight. Walking in a winter wonderland. Gone away is the bluebird. Here to stay.
Dude, it does not feel like it's gonna be Christmas in 10 fucking days, dude. Poopy and Mason for the sub. Hello, everybody flooding in. How is everybody doing on this fantastic fucking Thursday? It's React Day today, surprisingly. I know I don't normally do reacts on Thursdays. However, I will not be here Saturday and Sunday, so I'm doing reactions today, then some gaming. Tomorrow is going to be the cookie and milk tier list, which is going to be a little special stream that I won't be live Saturday and Sunday. So, to make up for that, because I wouldn't be able to be live doing reactions on Sunday because I'm not going to be live, and Friday's going to be the cookie and milk tier list, I'm doing reactions today, if that makes sense. So we're going to be doing reacts. Then we're probably going to be switching to either Fortnite, Valorant, or High on Life, one of the three, but it should be basically a full React Day today, and then some gaming tagged on the end. I'll let you guys vote on what game we play after, but that'll be fucking 3 hours from now. So, no worries on what we're going to be doing gaming yet. That'll be in a bit. But, we are going to start off with reactions. Before we do, does it feel like it's Christmas time to you guys? Somebody said, answer you, dick. Yeah, for sure. Hold up. Let me ban you from my chat. There it is. No, it doesn't feel like Christmas at all. I feel like I said the same damn thing last year. I don't know if it's because, like, global warming or some dumb shit, but it just doesn't feel like, dude, Christmas is in 10 days. 10 days. 10 days. It's Christmas. 10 days. You guys are off. Either now or probably, like, in 5 days. Like, it is almost Christmas. Doesn't feel like it. And I swear to God, bro, on Christmas Day, I'm gonna be doing, like, you know on Christmas Day how you, like, hang out with your family or you open gifts or some shit? I'm gonna be doing that, and it won't even feel like Christmas. I know I'm gonna be at a family party just being like, why are we all here right now? It's just, I don't know if it's aging or some shit. Dude, it just feels weird. It don't feel like Christmas at all. It doesn't even feel like winter. I feel like it was like May, like last month. Like, dude, we've been out of summer for 4 months now. I feel like it was August last month. We've already passed September, October, November. We're halfway through December. What the fuck? Brooke for the sub, Mason for the 300 bits. It was my 21st birthday yesterday. Happy late birthday. Hope you had a fun birthday. Tip-T-O-P-Tier for the sub. Dumpy for the sub, Stone for the 300 bits. Jokes for the 300 bits. Can I please have motivation to go to the gym? Just go to the gym. Why do you need me to yell at you? Just go to the gym. Just get up, go to the gym. Self-motivate. You know, you shouldn't need me to motivate you. Australia for the sub, J-Dog for the 300 bits. Deep Thoughts Thursday, week 6 at the hospital is the only building you left without entering. The hospital is the only building you left without entering. That's wrong. That's not facts. Because you still entered the hospital in your mom's stomach. At post-birth. Post-birth, it's the only building that you left without entering. But, like, you were ready to come out. Like, you weren't, like, a non-human fetus fucking blob. You were ready to be born. And then you still entered the hospital. I don't know. All right, whatever. Brooke for the sub, Coop for the sub, Grace for the 300 bets. First time donating. Watch 720 hours of you with 2K chats this year. Holy dub. I would consider that a dub. I would too. That's a fucking W chatter right there. Dominator, Joseph, Co, Edits, Herc, Hunter for the sub, Mason for the sub, Noon for the 300 bits. I-Hat, Joe for the sub, Nacho for the sub, Brioni for the 1,000 bits. It's so cold in Scotland, way colder than usual Decembers. Well, that's good. You should be happy it's cold. McLean for the 300 bits. Ever get into a family argument? Y'all ever get into a family argument during the holidays? Recently, no. But previous, I feel like every, even if you're not in the argument, there's always a family argument. Even if it's a small one. You ever see a big one, though? You ever have a family member get into a fist fight? Oh, that's the fucking, that's, dude, that's get popcorn on your lap. Sit there and fucking watch that shit unfold. Holy shit. Goddamn near everybody fucking beating the piss out of each other on fucking Christmas Day. Oh my god. Bro, that's the worst. McLean for the 300 bits. Joe for the sub. I had a mullet for the 300 bits. What is your opinion on the song Break Your Heart by Tayo Cruz? I've never even heard of that. I may have heard of it if I listened to it, but I don't know the song by name. Coop for the 300 bits. Just got done going to the gym. Thanks for the motivation. No problem. All right. Let's start off the reacts, shall we? First, we have I was sexually assaulted within the metaverse. Then we have a Darman elf backstabbed Santa Claus on Christmas. Then we have a bunch of how to survive videos. You guys said we should watch these the next react day, last react day. So we're going to watch these dumbass how to survive a grizzly bear nuclear apocalypse tsunami. We're probably going to rant about how stupid they are. A Charlie video, streamer gets angry and makes a horrible apology video. I've seen a clip of this, but not the entire video. And then we have these old videos of people trying to predict the future and failing miserably. So it should be a good-ass react day. W. Charlie. Bryn for the 300 bits. Doesn't feel like Christmas, it feels like Easter. Okay, that's cap. It does not feel like fucking Easter. I don't know where the hell you're getting that from. Stone for the 300 bits. How's your day? Good. How was yours? Noon for the 300 bits. Farted in class and shattered and there was no... Oh, sharded. Ooh. I farted in class and sharded and there was no toilet paper in the bathroom. So did you just shit... Did you just sit in your shitty pants the rest of the day? What did you do? Mogo for the sub, Mammon for the sub. Yo, this is not a thing in college, but when I was in high school, you ever have a classmate that, like, genuinely just reeks of shit? Like, just genuinely reeks of shit. Like, I'm saying, like, they don't smell like they haven't showered. Like, they smell like they shit their pants, right? But it's not like an, oh, they shit their pants probably. It's like, no, they always smell like shit. Like, they always, I don't know if it's a bad high, I've never asked them, right? Because I'm not gonna lean over. I mean, I'm out of high school now. But, like, at that time, I'm not gonna lean over and be like, bro, you fucking reek. Like, but it's not BO. You know how there's a difference between BO smell and, like, feces? It's like, it's not BO, right? It's not bad hygiene. It's feces, right? It's shit. It's shit, and they smell like shit. And you want to know, like, I'm not even mad. Like, I was never even mad about it. I just want to be like, bro, why do you smell like poop? Like... How, like, did you not wipe your ass? Like, I know, I'm not gonna sit there and be like, oh, you don't shower. Because then they would smell like BO. But, like, they smell like poop. Like, like, why do you smell like shit? Like, it might be swamp ass, right? It might be, my guess is that they didn't wipe their ass enough and they're sweating. And then it's that, like, you know, it's that, like, goo. Oh, God, stop, 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 stop. It's like that bad, it's like swamp ass. It's like a mixture of BO and shit, and it, like, amplifies the shit. That's what they smell like. But it's, like, their whole body. It's, like, their whole body. Dude, and everyone has a classmate that's like this, though. And it's not, yo, and y'all can tell me to stop. It's not like, oh, it's, like, emitting from their ass, right? Because then you would be like, oh, it's shit. But, like, no, they reek. Like, their armpits, their hair, their breath. Like, everything just smells like poop. Like, and I don't know why. Bro, you tell me I'm bugging, but, like, dude, dead ass. Like, my junior year, bro, I had this one kid in my class. I'm just sitting there. I dead ass leaned over one time and went, like, what the fuck? 3 inch for the 5,000 bits. Bro said Joe smells like green beans. Yo, green beans is my favorite fucking vegetable. What's the best vegetable? Green beans. I don't smell like green beans, though. There was a good time, though. Yo, the worst is after you eat, like, a frozen pizza and the top of your lip reeks of, like, cheese for, like, a day. Is that relatable? 3 inch, again, thank you for the 5,000 bits. Yo, that's an issue that I have. I don't know if that's relatable at all, but, like, it's not like when I get delivery pizza. It's like if I eat frozen pizza, the top of my lip just, like, smells like cheese. And it's so annoying. Okay, that one's a miss. That one's not relatable. But that's an issue I have. Noon for the 300 bits. I flushed my underwear down the toilet, then called my mom, and she picked me up. No damn way your underwear went down the toilet. Tip T-op for the 300 bits. Seki for the 300 bits. If you didn't have a classmate like this, it was you. Yo, dead ass. Yo, dead ass. If you didn't have a classmate that reeked of shit, you were the classmate that reeked of shit, okay? I know you probably, on a Thursday in December, you don't want me to be telling you this, but, like, if you don't have that classmate that smells like poop, you're the one that smells like poop, right? The same damn thing, right? It's the same damn thing with group chats, right? Every friend group has an alternate friend group chat without one kid in it, right? And if you're not into group chats, yo, and I'm not trying to stress y'all out. And this is going to stress so many people out right now because they're probably in one group chat. It's not a guarantee, but there's so many friend groups that, like, you have one main group chat and another one where one kid isn't in it. And if you don't have two group chats, you're probably not in one group. In my friend group, I'm probably not in a group chat that they're in. But, like, at the end of the day, here's how you deal with it. You just don't give a fuck. You just don't give a fuck. But I am in a group chat where one kid isn't in it. So, you know, there is a chance that I'm not that kid that's not in the group chat. But, yeah, no. That is actually a common friend group thing. I don't know if it's with women, but with guys specifically. That's how it is. Valorant stream ? Maybe after Reacts. I already explained. I'm doing Reacts today because the Cookie and Milk tier list is tomorrow. And so I can't do Reacts that day. And I won't be live Saturday and Sunday. So I can't do Reacts Sunday. So I still wanted to give you guys reactions this week. So I moved it to Thursday. We're still going to do gaming after Reacts. It's just a matter of what gaming we do. 3 inch. Again, thank you for the 5,000 bits. Do you remember me? Says Cold. Yes, I do. Carver for the sub. What's your opinion? Aren't you the kid that told me to remember you in, like, a specific timeline? What's your opinion on the UK? I don't really have it. Chat, what's your opinion on the UK? Most of my chat's from the US. They'll tell you. Toka Chai for the 3. Valorant Night Market's live with a skin bundle. I might go check that out today then. We might play Val after. With my new PC too. I haven't played Val on my new PC yet. Mammon for the sub. Mogo for the sub. Or on stream at least. Jokes for the 300 bits. Love your streams. We'll be late for tomorrow's stream. No problem. Carver for the sub. Noon, I already read that. Seki, I already read. I already read that too. Fuck, I'm just rereading bits. Wabbit for the 300 bits. If you play Dead Island 2 when it comes out, I've never even heard of that. Will you ever play Overwatch again? Don't know. Spider for the 300 bits. Pooped for the fucking 5 gifted subs. Dub in the chat for pooped. Spider for the 300 bits. We gotta get into the reacts. There's a girl who sat in front of me in class who puts on so much perfume whenever she comes to the class, I put my shirt over my nose. Does she see you do that? Because that's disrespectful. Hey, I'm not telling you not to do it, but. If you walk into class and she sees you go, yo, the kid that reeks like shit, do that. Next time they walk in class, go, or just start gagging when you're next to them. No, don't do that. That bring it up. If you're going to bring it up in a nice way. And I don't know how you could bring it up in a nice way to tell a kid that he smells like shit, right? But There probably is a way that you could be like, hey, you smell pretty fucking bad, right? JJ for the 1,000 bits. Thank you, Key, for the sub, and Duck for a buck for the 1,000 bits. You should start selling your bathwater. 2-inch would buy it. I don't think 2-inch would buy my... I don't know. 2-inch might buy my bathwater if I sold it. Sam for the 300 bits. React to FNAF tapes? Yeah, for sure. Yeah, guys, today we're going to be doing a 4-hour react stream to Markiplier's FNAF gameplay. Does that sound good? We're actually not even going to commentate. I'm just going to sit in the corner. I'm going to sit in the corner and eat popcorn while you guys watch FNAF, right? And I'm going to just sit here and I'm going to go. And just menacingly, in the dark, too. In the dark. All the lights off. All the lights off. I'm just going to sit in the corner menacingly while we watch a 55-minute Markiplier gameplay. I do watch long-ass videos for late nights. Oh, actually, chat. Would these videos... Yo, some of you guys also... Before we get into the reacts. Exclamation point Discord. Join the Discord. Send videos for me to react to for react days. It helps out a lot. You guys sent this video of Daz Games. It's a 52-minute video of him stranded on an island for a week. I'm not going to watch this on a regular react day. Do you guys want to watch this for a late night one day? Just, I would literally hop on and we would watch this only, this one video, right? Because with my pauses, a 52-minute video becomes a 2-hour fucking stream, right? So that's why I don't do those long-ass videos normally. Like, the longest video I'll normally watch on stream is, like, 20 minutes for a regular react day. Just because then it ends up being, like, dude, like, a Darman video that I watch could end up being an hour-long reaction. Like, we're supposed to be reacting right now. I've been live for 16 minutes just talking. Short for the sub. I mean, that's why you guys watch me, but still. all right, let's get into the fucking reacts. First video, I was sexually assaulted within the metaverse.
Helps make us better citizens of Allen. That's all. Thank you.
All right. Thank you. Appreciate that input. And I will tell you that since what you present is not necessarily on our agenda, we can't necessarily discuss it. But we can refer that to the city manager to have him.
Can you go? I've always wondered. There's so many clips of these people going to, like, city councils and just ranting. Are they not allowed to kick you out? Because, like, this guy's going to come up. This guy next is going to come up and just start rambling for, like, 5 minutes about something that has nothing to do with any of their jobs at all. This is your town?
Look into... doing something to respond to your comments.
The video was too loud? Okay. Somebody said, bro, just turn it off. Oh my god, are we already having an L chatter complain? Are we already having an L chatter complain? Oh my god. Yeah, we're 23 seconds into the video, man. Can we keep up the vibes today and not have motherfuckers be like, boring video! I'm not entertained by this video right now. Oh my god, dude. Give it like 5 fucking minutes. And then complain, right? Otherwise, when we're 20 fucking seconds into the video, just shut the fuck up. Just like, yeah, like we, it hasn't even gotten to the dude that's actually gonna fucking talk, right? Like, that was just the intro clip. Motherfuckers, like, that's like watching a fucking movie and, like, right when the fucking credit scene starts, like, rolling in and the intro of the movie starts, you're just like, all right, this movie sucks. I'm gonna leave. Like, you didn't even fucking get to the plot. Subway for the sub, Minx for the sub, 3-inch for the 300 bets, 3-inch EZAP for the 300 bets, David for the sub. After you're done with reactions you already picked, can you react to what I put, not trying to be an L chatter? I don't even know what you put, and no. Put it in the Discord, I might watch it another day, but I already have so many videos that we're doing today. I might not even watch all of them because we're still going to be doing gaming after, so I don't know for sure. But just send it in the video suggestion tab, and I will let you know. Oh, Zeusie just texted me about High on Life. He said, yo, did you guys like the High on Life stream yesterday, by the way? I thought it was good as shit. I'm definitely going to finish that game. Not today, necessarily, but we might play it today, depending. I'll poll you guys on what we're going to do. I'm assuming you guys will vote for Valor Fortnite, but we're going to play it eventually. It was fun as shit. Somebody said I fell asleep midstream. I'm sorry to hear that. David and Bondi for the sub. Lil Rax for the 3. I don't understand why the metaverse is really a thing. I understand the whole future thing, but come on. Have you guys ever gone into the metaverse? Like the fucking Zuckerberg VR shit? I've never done that. Will you be playing High on Life someday? Wow. I literally played it for 4 hours yesterday, Tip Top. You missed that. You missed a 4-hour stream yesterday. I played it for 4 hours straight. I'm like halfway through the game now. Pots for the sub. Or probably like a third, maybe. Luke for the sub.
Next, we have a primetime Stein.
Oh, God.
Hello, Mayor. My name is Primetime Stein. I'd like to keep my address private for personal reasons. I work at a popular Chili's. I want to start off by denouncing...
I work at a popular Chili's. I'd like to keep my address private. So the people at Chili's doesn't know who he is.
The Dallas Cowboys. I was a fan of them, but no longer am I a fan of them. They had a major executive, Rich Dalrymple, got in trouble for sexual assault. They had to pay $2.4 million to the cheerleaders because they were filming them illegally, as well as Jerry Jones has an illegitimate daughter named Alexandra Davis that he will not take credit for. And the reason why this is so pertinent today is because although I am a Dallas Cowboys fan, the reason why this is so important because I was recently sexually assaulted within the metaverse. And I...
What the fuck is that segue? What the fuck is that segue? But I was talking about the Dallas Cowboys. Said, you know, the reason this is pertinent is because it just brings up the metaverse.
I recently ordered a device from China that hooked up to my, there's some children in the room, so we have to be very careful of the words I use, but hooked up to some orifices of mine. And it was actually, they say on the manual, I don't know if you're familiar with it, Dave, but it's actually indistinguishable from actual physical intercourse. And I'll be honest, I was having a good time.
Oh my God, there's literally a kid behind him watching this speech. Oh my God.
It's got wildly insane. Other people's avatars were starting to take advantage of my avatar, and I felt helpless. I felt out of control, Dave. For the first time in my life, you know, I'm a tech guy, and this equipment was being used. A gargoyle was doing stuff to me. Somebody like Wendy's, the girl from the sandwich shop, you know, the hamburger, popular hamburger place, was doing stuff to me. It was absolutely frightening. It was something like you would see out of, you know, some sort of satanic movie. And I want to, the reason why I'm here, Chris, is because I need...
Bro, what the fuck is this guy talking about? Holy shit. Dan Burt for the sub, Lucas for the sub, Ryder for the three. Is a 500-pound bench good? For 19. Dude, a 500-pound bench is good at any age. If you can bench 500 pounds, you're stronger than, like, 99.9% of the population. LSO for the 500 bets. My dog died recently. I'm sorry to hear that. My mental health has been pretty bad. Your streams have helped me. I'm glad I could help, and I'm sorry that your dog passed away. Donnie for the 300 bets. These comedians, Chad and JT, do... Oh, wait, this is a comedian? I know this guy's fucking around, but... They do city council meetings all the time. They go to city council meetings anywhere and talk about random shit. And by law, they can't get kicked out. And the council has to listen to them. Should I go do this one day? Duck for the 300 bits. Take the headset off and equipment off. Like, what the fuck? Dude, he's not being serious. He's joking. He's not, he's not actually saying he got sexually assaulted in the metaverse. Lil Rax for the three. Are we not going to talk about the man's fit? Oh, yeah, that's the whole part of it, too. Yo, should I go and talk about the Disney sniffer? Bro. I should go and just give a whole-ass presentation about why the Disney sniffer exists. Bro, they would fucking have to listen to me. They would have to listen to me. That's insane.
Need your help getting Mark Zuckerberg's attention, because if this can happen to me, this can happen to other children.
I feel like they're not even, like, appalled. Like, is this, like, a normal thing for city council meetings?
Mayor Falk, I'm a professional comes to the internet. I'm on there all day long. So when I'm inside the metaverse, that's my second home. That's my second life. That's where I really grind and shine. I know I have a lot of flamboyance now. I'm handsome. I'm tall. You know, you think I check a lot of boxes here. But in the metaverse, I'm 10 feet tall. I'm balling. I got wings. Ah, ah! I'm like a bird.
Nah. Oh my God, bro. Dude, and the mayor just has to sit here and listen. Holy shit, bro. I feel like being a mayor would be the most entertaining job in the world then. Holy fuck. Nephilim for the sub.
Flying. You can't do that here.
Amar for the 300 bits. Thanks for what you're doing. Been feeling kind of shitty lately. Finally made it to the stream. Have a great day. I hope you have a great day, and I'm sorry that you've been feeling shitty.
That doesn't give them the right to sexually harass me or sexually assault me. They say, oh, look at Shorty, looking fine. They say some nasty stuff, way worse than that, and I have to censor myself because of the, you know, situation we're in. But I'm telling you, Dave, it can very easily happen to you. I don't know if you have an online account, but I'm telling you, you log into this, the Oculus 69.
Bro, I really want to see their faces. Like, I know it should be on him, but I want to see what the fuck their, like, their facial expressions. Are they just stone cold, like, why the fuck are you here? Bro said Oculus 69.
You plug this thing into it, you literally, it plugs into you, it feels great. But somebody on the other end can take advantage of you, and they can go too far, and that's what happens. So I need your help, Eric, getting the attention of Mark Zuckerberg. I need your help, Mayor Folk, bringing attention to this. So if this happens,
he's not fucking smart. Like, he's giving this whole ass speech, like, unfazed.
Again, it's not going to be me. It's going to be one of these kids. It's going to be you next time, Shelly. You're going to order it on HSN, Home Shopping Network. Oh, this is a great thing. I'm going to plug it in. I'm wearing it on my head. Next thing you know, you have a gargoyle doing stuff to you that you would never even imagine.
Gargoyle. Bro, what fucking server is he in the metaverse where this shit is going down?
That can happen to you. I want that to be known. So we need to bring attention to the sexual assault of the Dallas Cowboys. And we need to tell Mark Zuckerberg how I was sexually assaulted within the metaverse, Dave. I really need your help and your attention.
Your time has expired.
You. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Stein.
Bro, they ain't. Bro, he left the fucking chat restaurant, sir. Oh my god, I fucking misspoke out the ass there. He left the fucking Dak Prescott's jersey there. Are they gonna pick that shit up? Are they just gonna fucking leave it?
Next, we have Cassidy Campbell.
The city council invites citizens to speak on any topic not on the agenda or already scheduled for public hearing. Prior to the meeting, please complete a public meeting appearance card and present it to the city secretary. The time limit is 3 minutes per speaker, not to exceed a total of 15 minutes for all speakers. Oh, so they only let 5 people speak. Do they all just say random shit? Like, is this guy serious, or was he about to do some shit? All right. Kai for the sub, Pack for the 500 bits. Love your videos. The first time seeing you live. Have a great day. Thank you, Tilly and Freddy, for the sub. And Pop Sosa for the $25 dono. Dup. Thank you, Pop Sosa, for the 25. I mean, it's a common problem going in the metaverse. I've had it happen 2 or 3 times. Is sexual assault really a problem in the metaverse? I feel like I should not Google this. I'm literally Googling, is sexual assault a problem? Sexual assault in the metaverse is a part of a bigger problem that technology won't solve. Wow. It can be? How the fuck? Dude, what are you... Is the metaverse... I don't even understand what the fucking metaverse is. Is the metaverse just VR? Like, what is the metaverse? And Pop Sosa for the $25 dono. Thank you. Dan Burt for the 300 bits. Wanted to say love your content. Hope you and your family have a great Christmas. Thank you. Love from Sweden. I'm glad I have a Swedish viewer. It's like VR chat. It's like VR, but differently. It's like a Facebook VR. Mostly VR. It's like VR chat for old people. Oh my god. Dude, I kind of want to... Wait, if I get a VR headset, would I be able to go into the metaverse? Because I'm getting a VR headset for VR Among Us one day. Should I go into the metaverse? Bro, it's probably boring as shit. I feel like they're making it seem like there's so much shit going on that's either good or bad or whatever. But, like, I feel like the majority of metaverse interactions is just, like, blatantly nothing. Like, you're just walking around in, like, an office building in VR, and there's nothing there. Chebbles for the sub. Doc for the 300 bits. Brooke and Joe search history seeing metaverse sexual assault. Elf backs to... Okay, next video. Chebbles for the sub. Elf backstabs Santa Claus on Christmas. What happens next is shocking. The only Darman video we're fucking watching today. All right, so don't ask for another one after this shit. Donnie for the 300 bits. Send a chat and JT City Council in the Discord. I will go look another day. Exclamation point Discord if you guys want to send videos in the video suggestion tab. That's how I find a lot of the videos that I react to. Not all of them, obviously. A lot of them I find myself. But you guys can send me a lot of videos. It makes it so I don't have to search for a lot of them. Because if you guys send me good videos, then I can just queue them up. And then I get to watch the videos that you guys want me to watch as well.
Okay, lady. What do you want for Christmas?
The worst Santa ever. Bro, that shit is... That is a fucking terrible-ass mask right there. Or not mask, beard. I bought a... Yo, dead ass, for this cookie and milk tier list on Friday, tomorrow, I bought a whole-ass Santa costume. $90. I haven't tried it on yet. It might not fit me. It better fit me. Because I don't think I can return it. It better fucking fit. It better fucking fit. It better not look boof like that, too.
Lady, what do you want
it's
for?
Probably that dead, it's probably dead ass that outfit. It's all, I'm almost sure that it's probably that outfit.
Christmas.
How about a Christmas tree?
You want a Christmas tree?
Uh-huh.
For Christmas?
Yeah.
Oh,
what a dumb gift. What a dumb gift to ask for. Santa, could I have a Christmas tree on Christmas? What are you gonna do with it then? What are you gonna do with it then? You got no damn Christmas tree. You're gonna have a Christmas tree. What do you do with it then? Now it's done Christmas. Now you take that shit down. Right after Christmas is over, you fucking get rid of the... When do you guys get rid of your Christmas tree? Like, right after. Like, the next day. Like, December 26th. That bitch is getting fucking ripped off. Maybe New Year's. You might wait to New Year. Yeah, New Year's Day, maybe. Like, January 1st, January 2nd, right? That's the latest. You're going to ask for a Christmas tree for Christmas? I feel like that's a shitty gift. Lucas, bro, yo, if this... Yo, Lucas, if you raid me one more time, I'm permabanning you. You are nonstop one person raiding me. Why? You're one person raiding me, watching yourself. L raid. Not a W raid. L raid, dude. You're streaming, you're watching your own stream on your own account, and then you raid me. It's just maintaining the same person. You have not added any, you're raiding me yourself, like 10 times too. Literally. Left for the three. This is the last of the money, have a good Christmas. Also, my friend EXO is in the chat, so bye, ILY. Who is EXO? What do you mean, EXO? Last of the money, have a good Christmas. Thank you.
Okay, we can do that. Anything else?
An iPhone 14!
sorry, those are sold out.
Yo, the fucking beard has fallen off.
Even for
those are sold out. I thought Santa makes the iPhone 14s.
Santa, but, how about a picture?
Yeah.
Oh. hey, no photos or videos with your phone. Come on.
What is the problem?
What's the problem? I'm a professional photographer that shoots in 20 megapixels. Much better than you.
Yo, I'm telling that guy to shut the fuck up. I'm telling that man to shut the fuck up. Deadass. Day I have a kid and I pay that $15, $20. For my kid to sit on some dumbass fucking old guy's lap that's dressed as Santa Claus, and I take a pic. I'm gonna take a picture on my fucking phone. I ain't paying them fucking $45 extra for this dumbass. I'm a professional photographer. You work at a mall. All right. You're not a professional photographer. All right. This is a hobby at most. You're the mall Santa Claus photographer, okay? This ain't some big gig. You're not in Iceland taking pictures of fucking nature and puffins. You're not taking pictures of models. This ain't no clothing shit. This ain't no nature view. You're taking pictures of people sitting on some old dude's lap with a fucking fake beard. Or not a fake beard. They usually have a real beard. They usually cast old people.
Oh, okay, old parents! Let's have a little Christmas spirit!
Yo, worst Santa ever. Holy shit. This is already pissing me off.
I think it's okay if she takes a few pictures.
Well, I don't. If you don't put it away, I'll take it from you.
What's going on over here?
Yo, I'll drop your dumbass. Yo, I'ma be that dad that gets in a fist fight in a fucking mall. I'ma be that, yo, I don't give a shit. Yo, I'm dead at, yo, no, yo, that dickhead says I'll take, yo, try it. Yo, I'll take, yo, you either stop taking photos or I'll take your phone from you. Yo, fucking try it, dickhead. I'm breaking his nose. Oh, I'm breaking his nose. Yo, that's gonna be the most traumatizing fucking thing my kid's ever gonna fucking witness. Me fist fighting the Santa photographer. Yo, dead ass. I don't give a shit.
I am sick of this job.
Then that's quit.
That's what. No one respects me. And I, you know, quit.
Oh my god, you deleted like 5 photographs. Oh no, it's not like they can just sit back down and retake the picture. No! Where shall we ever get someone to literally just press dink on a fucking button, dude? This ain't some you gotta change the light fixtures and shit. Just hand me the fucking camera, I'll take the damn picture. Anyone could do the mall Santa job. All right? Anyone. Nature photography, model photography, where you gotta fuck with the settings and shit and the angles. That's different than taking a damn portrait photo of somebody sitting on Santa's lap, asshat. Danda for the sub, pop for the 3. You're all talk. I'm all talk. Dude, I'd fight a mall Santa. I would fist fight a mall Santa. Not even the photographer. I'd fist fight a mall Santa. No doubt. No doubt. I'm not gonna approach them and like just start fighting, right? But in a scenario where a mall Santa wants to throw down, right? I would throw down with the mall Santa. I'd probably lose. Cause how, like, mall Santas are pretty big. Mall's ex cosmics for the sub. Mall Santas are pretty fucking big. And they got experience, right? I feel like I might get my ass kicked. That would be really sad if a mall Santa beat the piss out of me. That'd be a good clip though. That'd be me getting my head like fucking just curb stomped by a mall Santa.
I guess somebody's going on the naughty list.
Those are Chips Ahoy, bro.
Hey, that's for Santa, not you.
Why does Santa need all the cookies? He doesn't need them. Have you seen his belly?
Buddy, please.
That is not how I perceived this interaction going down, bro. It's a fucking cookie. I thought she was going to be like, why aren't you doing your job? She's really bitching about him grabbing a cookie.
Hey, that's for Santa, not...
I understand he's stealing them, and that is... But it's more so... Not, that's for Santa, not you. And it's more so, what the fuck are you doing? You're a grown-ass man trying to steal cookies from a plate. Maybe do your job. Like, what the fuck is he doing? He's not even in the photo. He's just trying to steal a cookie and go backstage and eat it.
You.
Why does Santa need all the cookies? He doesn't need them. Have you seen his belly?
Buddy, please, I can't do this right now. I just lost a photographer, and I don't want to get Santa upset, too.
It's always about Santa. When is it going to be about me for once?
Your job is to be his little helper. Now be a good sport and go take some photos. Please. Kids are waiting.
Why can't he eat a damn cookie, bro? They're probably fucking 10 cents.
Hey everybody. It's Buddy the Elf!
Dude, you can see his other beard under that.
Does he know how to do that
mailroom
dance from Elf?
Of course he does! Come on, Buddy! Do the dance!
No, I'm not doing that.
Oh, Buddy! Oh, do the dance, Earl!
Oh, no, I'm thrown down with the Santa. I'm thrown down with the Santa. Yeah, that Santa's a dick, bro. Yo, Elf backstab Santa Claus? Nah, this ain't even a lesson. The Elf backstab Santa Claus? Bro, the elf is just fucking... just sticking up for himself. Bro's trying to boss him around. Santa Claus bosses Elf around, gets backstabbed. That why the fuck are we blaming the Elf here? The Elf did nothing wrong.
To tickle you!
Fine.
Oh my god.
Yeah! Oh, buddy!
Yeah, I'm pretty sure you'll love these photos.
Santa, Santa, Santa. This is what everyone always talks about.
Well, he is the star of the show. More coffee?
No,
just bro, somebody said get sturdy, ref. Stop.
Oh.
Captain Morgan? I was pulling a whole ass mug. Holy shit.
I mean, why does he get to be the main character?
Bro's drinking on the job, 1 p.m. at a fucking local mall.
Aren't you sick of that, too?
No, I kind of like playing reindeer. Plus, his job's a lot of work.
How much do mall Santas get paid? Cap for the sub, Yeniel for the sub, Daddy for the sub. Mall Santa salary. The average annual pay for a mall Santa is $47,000 a year. Bro. But they only work like, what, a month? That's not true, bro. An average mall Santa makes $22 an hour. $264 a 12-hour shift. See, yeah, no, there's no, that's just fucking false. You know, ZipRecruiter, my fucking ass, that's just wrong. That's wrong. There's no way that's right. Maybe if they're doing other side gigs dressed as Santa, but, like, when the fuck does somebody order a Santa Claus? Like, outside of, like, late November and all of December.
You know, like my friend Prancer always says.
Prancer, Rudy, you're not a real reindeer. They're only paying us minimum wage for this gig.
No, I really
minimum wage? Minimum wage? I gotta fucking dress as an elf? Minimum wage? I gotta dress as a fucking reindeer? Hop around? Oh, get the fuck out of here.
I'm Prancer.
The whole ass phone number. You think that's real? Nah, that's probably a phone number they get you to call and they sign you up for one of those fucking things that just texts you. You know when all those YouTubers, like, tweet out, like, the YouTubers that, like, fucking scam their fans and they're like, text me at, and it's like a 1-800 number. And then you text them and then it's literally just a fucking... It's just like a fucking setup thing that just puts you on like a list that spams the shit out of you.
Well, anyways, like he always says, the grass isn't always...
What do you call it? Everybody's saying call it. What do you call it? Fuck off. Everybody's saying call it. What do you call it? Oh, everybody wants me to call it. What do you call it? Why do I gotta call it? Why do I gotta fucking do it? Yo, oh, okay. We want to see the streamer do it. Oh, fuck off. Ryan.
Greener on the other side. He's right.
Well, my grass is dead. That pre-search Santa
Buddy,
is...
why aren't you dressed? Santa needs your help, so please get a move on. Well, I guess since you're dressed, you can go ahead and entertain the kids. Let's go, Chop-Chop!
Listen, Mabel. I have an idea. Hear me out. What if we do, like, a little special meet and greet with Buddy? You know, dancing elf? I'm way cooler than Santa than nowadays, so...
Oh, that's cute. I thought you were being serious for a moment.
You're thrown down with my manager, too. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Why is everybody being a dick to him? And this is going to end up with him being like, oh, he's the bad guy. Bro, all he's trying to do is get, like, a fucking higher lead. He's trying to actually do something. Holy shit.
Oh, you're being serious.
Ryan for the sub.
Yeah, that would never happen. I mean... Maybe if Santa calls in sick or something, and even then, it'd still be a big if. Now, please get dressed and go help Santa. It seems urgent. Buddy, the dancing elf. That's funny.
I'm so sick of the job. Why can't I be big and fat like Santa? Oh no, you can't be Santa Claus unless he calls out.
Hey, buddy.
Yeah, what's up? Maybe we'll say you need help with something?
Yeah. Could you go get me some milk? You know, I like to dip my cookies.
Are you serious? That's the big urgency?
Are they trying to portray this as, like, he's actually Santa Claus? I don't get it. Like, because they refer to him as Santa. Like, I feel like off work, they would be like, yo, Bob, shut the fuck up. Like, why is the elf waiting on him? Like, I think they're trying to actually make him seem like Santa.
I'm pretty sure there's plenty more in the fridge.
No, I looked. It's all whole milk, you know?
And you know how sensitive my stomach is. You know, it's just almond milk for me.
You know, how about you get your...
Say it. Say it. How about you get your own damn milk, bitch? How about you say that?
I will get you the milk. I mean, like you said, we won't leave you with a sensitive stomach while they're taking photos of you.
Right? You know, buddy, you get me. They don't make them like you.
They don't make what like him? They don't make what like him? Bro, this guy's... Nah, this Santa's something else. This Santa's something else right now. Barna for the sub. Bro, no damn way. That's the reindeer. Do they even hire like extras for mall Santas? Like when I used to take pictures with a mall Santa, it was just the Santa. They didn't have no damn elf. This dude's in fucking sneakers and a fucking reindeer onesie just fucking lurking. Oh my god, is he putting laxatives in it?
Good, you here. Cover me, will you?
Cover you for what? What are you doing?
I'm here for this. I'm here for this. Oh, yeah, I'm here for that. Oh, yeah, I'm here for that. Yep, there we go. There we go, Tub. There we go. He'll fucking shit himself.
Don't.
Hey, Santa, I went ahead and got you ice-cold almond milk just the way you like.
Oh, thank you! Because Santa's really thirsty!
Hey, Santa, can we get a photo?
Oh, yes!
The fuck happened? Is that the same dude as before? Oh, that's a different guy. They got a whole ass new photographer.
Of course!
Say cookies!
Cookies! Now, hey, I don't know how realistic a million Robux is. But I'll talk to Mrs. Claus for you.
Nah, if I'm Mall Santa, if I'm ever a Mall Santa, I'm being dead ass with them, right? I'm being dead ass with them. If they over ask, then yo, chat, pretend I'm Santa. Tell me what you want for Christmas, but say something that's like too expensive. Don't say like a car, right? Say something that'd be like a bit too much to ask for, right? Oh, what do you want? What do you want for Christmas today, Sonny? A PS5? I don't know if Santa's elves can be making those this year. Maybe you could settle for PS3? PS3, maybe a few used games? Maybe a few used games from it? How's that? How's that sound? See, I'm not going to be like, no. But I'm going to say, you're not getting that shit. A golden chain. You know, Santa doesn't actually make gold. How about one of those chains that actually just makes your neck purple? How about one of those fake ones from China that actually just makes your neck purple? How's that sound? A golden chain? I don't know. I'm thinking more one of those iced out ones that is quote-unquote free, but you have to pay for shipping. I fell for one of those scams, by the way. You guys ever fall for one of those scams? Supreme Patty. I fell for his scam when I was like, I think like 14. Supreme Patty. I bought one of his chains. I bought one of his necklaces. He had like, it was like a swipe up, the swipe up to get iced up. I knew it was a fake chain, right? But it looked good, right? It was this chain. It was this exact chain. It was back when I used to wear a cross, right? It wasn't the cross that I was actually wearing in my videos, but this is like before, like way before TikTok, right? And I bought that, and it was free, and it took like 4 weeks to get to my house, but I had to pay like $15 in shipping. I was like, wow, that's like actually really expensive for something so tiny. Looking back at it, oh my god, they just pocketed the money off of the shipping.
All right, so I'm pretty sure your mouth was dry from that. Just drink up.
Absolutely, let's do it. Oh, hey, kiddo.
We got a whole ass list.
What do you want for Christmas? Oh, let's see. Well, that's a long list.
I was in Goodyear for nothing. I expect this to be here by 10 p.m. on Christmas.
I'm gonna take a blowtorch. Burning that shit. Do I got a torch near me? I don't. Dude, I would take a blowtorch. I'm fucking burning that shit. Fucking burn. Oh, you expect what to be here at 10 p.m.? Oh, you expect what to be here at 10 p.m.? How does some socks sound? How does some socks sound for Christmas? Does that sound good? Does that sound good? So maybe some Minion socks and ones that are one size too small, so then they actually kind of stretch too much and Bob looks kind of deformed. How does one of those sound? How about some Minion socks that are one size too small? How about a toothbrush? How about maybe a good puzzle? How's that sound? How does that sound? Maybe a toy that's like 5 years too young for you. You know, you're expecting maybe a gaming console. How does like, you know, a Dora the Explorer game sound? How does that sound? Good?
We'll keep it.
Okay. How about a picture?
I just want the gifts. See ya.
How about you shut the fuck up? How about you sit the fuck down and ask for something reasonable?
All right, Santa, third time we try.
Actually, I do want it. Sorry, Mr. Elf.
Cookies.
Yo! And that fucking photographer being a dick for no reason, taking a picture of him for why?
Hey, buddy. Got milk?
Strangling him right there. It's gonna be the elf fight scene right there and then. Garlic for the 300 bits. I want a PC setup. Coco for the 1,000 bits. I'm sorry I'm late. I had school. Have a good day. Dude, you don't have to apologize for being late. I say this every day. You can show up to stream whenever. You don't have to show up either. It's entirely optional. Thank you for the 1,000 bits, though. Thank you for showing up. Garlic says, I want a PC. How does, you want a PC setup, you know? You're not being very specific there. How does a used Dell from, like, you know, maybe 2005 sound? One of those Dell PCs where when you click on Google, it doesn't load. And you have to spam click it like 40 times and then all the tabs open up at once like 10 minutes later. How does that sound? You ever have one of those PCs? Those are the good ones, right? One of those PCs, you know, it runs fine. It'll be able to get the task done. But like everything's, you know, maybe 5-10 minutes delayed after you press it. Even when you type, it doesn't show up right away. That's the fucking worst. That's actually hell. That's the fucking worst. What I could envision hell as. Me sitting on a shitty Dell PC, not a new one, like an old Dell, and you hit Google and it doesn't open. And so you just keep fucking pressing it, and like 5 minutes later, every tab just opens up at once. And then you gotta individually close all of them. Johnny for the sub.
Buddy, what are you doing in here?
Thought you were Santa for a sec. Hey, you ever wonder why Santa gets the big room? Like, seriously, you guess the candies, the milk and cookies, the nice sofa. Meanwhile, we all get folding tables.
No. Okay, buddy, whatever's going on with you right now, it needs to stop. You gotta, like, try meditating or something.
Meditating?
That's what you do when you stress? You meditate?
No. I actually fly around the city. That's how I relieve my stress.
How many times I gotta tell you, man? You're not a reindeer. You can't fly.
No. Yes, I can fly. Look, I got my pilot license.
Oh my gosh. Yo, that is the most photoshopped picture I have ever seen.
But, you know, if Santa would have drank that milk, that would have been a really bad situation.
That would have been fucking hilarious. A mall Santa shitting themselves. That would have been fucking hilarious.
Please don't do anything else dumb.
I'm gonna retry that. I'm gonna redo the fucking laxative. They kill it.
Get it. Look at me. I'm Santa Claus. Ho, ho, ho. I eat cookies, drink milk all day while everyone works.
Hey, buddy. That's a nice hat. Go quit your day job.
Yeah.
Hey, what you doing in my office?
Nothing. I was just gonna get you beard oil. You know, your beard look kind of dry lately, so.
Oh. Yeah, it is, isn't it?
It's a fake beard. What do you need beard oil?
Thank you.
When are you playing High on Life again? I don't know. I'm gonna finish the game for sure, though.
Oh, it's empty. You know what? Actually, would you mind getting another one of these? Because I gotta use the restroom. They're all out of almond milk, and I have that vitamin D. Gotta get things shifted around, if you know what I'm talking about, right? All right.
Yo, can we fast forward a bit, chat? This video is long as hell. Dude, Darman's been uploading, like, fucking 30-minute videos. I'm gonna go here. We're gonna just fast forward a minute.
Sure.
Because most of it's, like, filler. Bro, see, now we're getting to the plot, bro. Found the cookies.
Anybody got ice on Santa?
Negative.
Do you want me to meet and greet with the kids? I don't mind taking over.
Yeah, we might have to do that. Bro, that cat...
Want me to meet and greet with the kids? I don't mind taking over.
Bro's in the back just fucking messing with the lights. The viewer count just dropped. Yo, thanks for informing me, man. Yeah, make sure to tell me every time. Like, shut the fuck up. I'm sorry. I'm not trying to be a dick, but, like, why are you telling me that? The viewer count just dropped, okay? That's how Twitch works. I'm not trying... That was a bit rude on my part, but, like, why are you coming in my chat and fucking spamming that?
Over.
Yeah, we might have to do that if Santa doesn't get here. What?
The viewer count actually rose? Well, I can't tell. I don't see my viewer count right now. But, like, dude, motherfuckers come in my chat. 20 people just left the stream. Thanks for letting me know. Why are you... Okay, and? Yo, it's Ryzen, bro, or however you say your name. Not trying to be a dick there. That was my fault that I got pressed. But, like, it's just like, why are you telling me that? Like, it has no relevance to anything.
I used the beard oil, buddy. Came in and it turned my beard green.
Don't look at me, all right? I went to the store, like you said, and I don't know, maybe it expired or something.
I don't know. I can't go out there like this. It'll be a catastrophe.
You're right.
You ain't got another fake fucking wig?
Buddy, do you mind covering for Santa?
Do I mind? I would love to.
Look! Santa has a green beard!
I know you guys are expecting Santa to have a white beard, but...
We love the green beard! Yeah. Yeah, it looks Christmassy.
It's very creative and festive. Hey, you mind taking a picture with my boy?
Well, yes, of course you can!
Well, that didn't turn out how I expected it. It's gonna be a big hit. Thanks, buddy.
Yeah, thanks, buddy. Hey, you know what? You should get a paintbrush.
Bro, this is painful to watch.
Cookies.
Just stab the Santa. Just stab the Santa already. When you see backstabs, do you think he actually stabs the Santa? I doubt it.
Cookies.
Man, I can't believe I actually liked his green beard.
Yeah. Well, I tried to tell you to stop. You know, your plans just keep backfiring. Besides, Chris is a nice guy. You know, he bought all these gifts for the kids with his own
Jen for the sub, Straw for the sub, X the big man, and Johnny for the sub.
Time.
You know, I just gotta be faster, smarter, and cunning. What would the Grinch do?
He'd probably steal all the presents.
Set the mall on fire.
Wait, don't. I know that look. Come on, don't even think about it, buddy. I'm serious.
Come this way. Just put the cult down over here.
Arson.
It's gonna look great.
That's what the Grinch would do. Arson. He would burn the tree. Commit arson. That's what he would do.
The photo shoot.
You got it.
Now, let's go get the rest of the props. Rudy, would you mind giving us a hand?
Oh, yeah. No, sure. Yeah,
what do you think he does? What do you think he does to sabotage it? He just looked at that naughty and nice bag. I don't know. Kill the Santa? I don't think he kills the Santa. I don't think he's at that point.
Kids will be once they find out the gifts are empty.
Oh, they're actually just gonna get rid of the gift. Oh,
shoot, it's too light. Unless...
Oh, he's swapping out all the gifts for coal.
Ho, ho, ho! Who wants some early Christmas presents? Here's one for you! And here's one in here for you! Argus! Ho, ho, ho! Here's another one for you!
They're giving them fucking shoe boxes filled with random shit. Even if it wasn't filled with coal, I feel like that's a shitty gift. A shoe box with some weird-ass fucking Lego toy in it. Why not just give them the Lego toy? Why are you putting it in a shoebox?
Don't worry, little one. There's one more in there.
Oh, not even wrapped.
Special one for you. Okay, everybody. Open them up. What is this? Is this some kind of sick joke? Huh? Santa?
No.
You think the parent would get that mad? Like, if I was that, yo, if you were the dad, would you give a shit? I would be like, who cares? It's not. My kid might start crying or some shit, but I'd probably laugh. I would be like, bro, I'd be like, son, it's fine, man. It's not a big deal. You know, Santa gave you coal. This is a fucking mall Santa, all right? It's not a big deal. Like, bros actually live it.
No, I got them all toys. What is this? No, this doesn't make any sense.
Why did you play such a mean prank on children like this?
We are leaving. Come on, honey. This is a disgrace. Santa Claus, more like the Grinch.
Okay. Santa Claus, more like the Grinch. Oh, no. Fucking dumbass dad. All these dads are being losers. Holy shit.
No!
Don't throw out the random boxes with coal in it.
No, please. Please don't go. I can fix this.
Oh, Santa, this isn't your fault. This.
Hey, what happened?
I don't know. I got the toys just like I was supposed to. It doesn't make any sense.
Bro's about to cry. Bro's about to cry. Bro's actually about to fucking cry that the gift, it doesn't make any sense. I got them all the $1 gifts from Five Below. And like you guys said to, and then the parents got mad at me.
This is gonna be a PR disaster. All those parents were taking photos. I just hope this doesn't hit the news.
It's all my fault.
Bro, you're a local mall Santa. This shit ain't gonna hit the news, okay? Don't worry.
First the beard goes green, and then, what, coal and the gifts? What am I doing wrong?
Hey, stop. This isn't your fault, okay? There was a mix-up somewhere. We'll figure something out, okay?
I already have it figured out. I'm gonna have to take some time off.
What? No! You can't take some time off. There's only a few days until Christmas. The kids need you.
I'm under a lot of stress, right? And all I do is, I eat cookies, gain a bunch of weight. And then...
Bro's having a midlife crisis. Bro is questioning reality right now. Actually fucking... What's like the point in life, man? I'm just like... I'm a mall Santa, and, like, all I do is eat. Like, okay, yeah, question your life. Maybe do something else. Like, this isn't this elf's fault. Bro's gonna go to his villain arc. He's gonna become the Joker.
Jessica and me, we're having problems at home.
Oh, my God.
Yesterday, she got pretty mad at me for forgetting the eggnog. I don't know how I forgot. And I have a list. I checked it twice.
A Santa reference? Oh, Santa reference. Oh, Santa. Oh, you got me on that one. You checked it twice. Find out who's naughty or nice. Yo, you check that shit.
I gotta do this.
What am I supposed to do then? How am I going to replace you in such a short notice?
Well, talk to Rudy.
Find any old guy on the street. Literally any old guy on the street. That's what most mall Santas are, dude.
You know, or go to the elf, Buddy. He's great with kids. I'm sorry. I'll be in touch.
Has anyone seen Chris? I feel really bad about what happened.
Chris isn't here, Buddy. Congrats. You're the main character now.
Good shit. Good shit. Good shit. Dub. Dub. Buddy's the fucking Santa Claus now. Yep, yep, yep. Do the floss. Yep, yep.
Rudy! Where is the elf? Here he goes. Go. All right. This is your moment. Don't blow it.
Hi, I'm Buddy the Elf. What's your name?
Where's Santa?
Oh, ruined it already. Ruined it already. All right, this ain't gonna work. They're all gonna ask, where's Santa? Yep, every one of them's gonna say, where the fuck is Santa Claus? Where the fuck is Santa? Why am I talking to an elf? Where's your boss? Tell me where your manager is. Tell me where your manager is. That's kids with elves. It's like Karen's at a fucking restaurant. Where's your manager? Where's Santa?
Right here, right now, he's handling some business in North Pole. But don't worry, he hears everything that I say. So what would you like for Christmas?
I'd like a meet and greet with Darman.
Bitch, that's that. Congratulations for the most dumb gift, for the dumbest gift this fucking episode. Holy shit. A fucking meet and greet with Darman? Oh my god.
All I want is the Darman app for Christmas. All I want is maybe some Darman merch so I can show my friends I'm dripped out with the Darman gear.
All right. You sound like you've been a good kid. I'll make that happen.
Great. Where is he?
Like I said, he's not here right now, but I'm pretty sure you'll be able to see him soon, okay?
Don't make me mad. I want to see him right now. Right now!
Sorry.
No, we're not done.
Dude, that's giving me like a worry, like a panic in my body just when... When kids throw tantrums, dude. Ah! Like, the day I have a kid, if I'm in public, bro, and that kid just starts kicking and screaming and whining, bro. Oh, my. Wherever I am, I'm leaving. Wherever I am, I'm going to say, bro, if you don't come. This is dead ass what I'm telling my kid. If I'm anywhere with my kid when I'm older, and he just starts. I'm not saying like a toddler. I'm saying when they're like 7. If they just start having a fucking tantrum, I'm gonna say, if you don't shut the fuck up, we're dipping, all right? We're going home. I don't care that we're at the movies. I don't care that we're doing... If you don't relax, if you don't fucking calm the fuck down, we're out, right? Because we're ruining everybody's day. You fucking high pitch... Ah! Fuck, it is just making everybody want to die, right? So you gotta either calm the fuck down or we're leaving, right? Because every time I'm in public and I just hear a kid screaming, like just blood-curdling scream, oh, it ruins my day. It ruins my day, dude. Holy shit. Or they're just overtly loud. Oh, my God. Kids just... And it's not their fault, right? I'm not going to sit there and say, oh, my God, it's the kid's fault. Like, yeah, the kid annoys the shit out of me. But the reason the kid is annoying the shit out of me is because the parent sucks, right? When you see that happening in public... You get mad at the kid, but in reality, you should say, oh, that parent's a shitty fucking dad. Oh, that's a shitty mom. Because they don't actually fucking teach their kid how to be not a dickhead in public. And I'm not saying like, oh, some like, oh, they have to conform to society or some shit. But like, maybe don't throw a temper tantrum in the middle of a mall.
We're not done.
My turn!
Hold on, wait. Austin, what'd I tell you about using those wrestling moves on people you don't know?
Sorry about that. You okay?
Yeah, I'm pretty jolly. Say cookies!
Cookies!
Let's get another one for safety. Alright, that's enough photos.
Austin, come on, let's go.
Bro didn't even say what he wanted for Christmas. Bro just tackled the elf, took a fucking a little quick flick, and then dipped.
You seem normal.
I'm not finished with you, elf.
What are you doing? I was here first.
Too bad, so sad. Go away.
Okay, kids, you don't have to.
Fight! World star!
I said move!
Hey, why don't you teach your kids some manners?
You are cool streamer started watching your stuff on YouTube. Keep up the good work, man.
Eric 4011 or 4011. Thank you for the $100 fucking dono, dude. Oh my god. Dub in the chat for that. Thank you for the $100 dono, bro. That means a fucking lot to me. Holy shit. Thank you for the $100 dono. That's actually a fucking dub. That's actually a fucking dub, dude. Oh my god. That for the sub. I think I missed a shitload of other bits, too. Hold up. Let me catch up on those. But Eric4011, thank you for the fucking $100 dono, man. I'm glad you like my content. I'm glad I could entertain you. And thank you for the fucking $100. That for the sub. Jamboski for the 300 bits. When I sharded on Monday on the Minecraft stream, my family found out and now is making fun of me. I don't believe that you sharded, right? And that, like, everyone in your family knows you shit yourself and now they all make fun of you. Like, I feel like that's just unfeasible. Glad for the 300 bets. I caught my mall Santa smoking weed on the way to the restroom. Oof. Santa's hitting a fucking blinky. Santa's going to Blinkerton, Blinkertown, Yodi Land, Frothy for the sub. Kid Cotton for the sub, Stray for the 300 bets. Buddy literally is a short temper. Yeah. All right.
Don't you dare speak to me.
Eric, again, thank you for the $100 donut, man. Oh, somebody redeemed Flex. Santa Claus in Yodi Land. Bro is literally attending Yodi Land. He's no longer in the North Pole.
All right, good to get everyone to calm down. We can't have everyone fighting. I'm pretty sure
it was my son's turn.
We were already here.
You're already here.
World star! World star! Fight. Fight. Actually start fist fighting, bro. If I watched a fucking fight in a Darman video, I would shit myself. Oh my god.
You gotta get back in line.
My son is
Say
cookies.
Cookies. My son has been waiting for a very long time for just have a picture with
him. I couldn't imagine it happened like this at all.
Yeah, well, I tried to warn you.
How long would y'all wait in line for a mall Santa? For your kid, how long would you wait in line? Cole for the 300 bets. Eric for the 10 gifteds too. Holy dub. Thank you, Eric, for the 10 gifted subs. And Racked for the 5. Thank Racked or Eric if you got a sub from them. And thank both of you, Racked and Eric, for the fucking subs. Racked for the 5 gifteds and Eric for the 10. Thank you for the gifteds. Cole for the 300 bets. My Nana's doing cartwheels down the highway. What? Jamboski for the 300 bets. It was real. They were making fun of me. Oh, damn. Well, if you actually shit your pants, I'm sorry to hear that. I would wait like 10, 15 minutes. Like, I've seen like big malls, like the King of Prussia Mall or like the Mall of America. There's a bunch of malls that are massive, right? And people wait in line for like an hour for that mall Santa. Fuck no. Luke for the sub. Fuck no. Fuck no. I'm not waiting that damn long for some dickhead to fucking sit there and tell and talk to my kid and be like, oh, what do you want for Christmas? For 2 minutes? Yeah, okay. Leo for the sub, Viper for the sub, and Eric for a tier 1 sub and the 10 gifteds, and Ractor for the fucking 5. Thank you.
You know, I'll be right back. Gotta go help Prince load up his sled before tonight.
Big boy,
I'm not gonna say this again. You're not a real reindeer. You don't have to.
No, it's for his kids. We rented one to take one up to the mountains.
Oh my god, bro. Holy fucking shit. Fast forward.
Thank goodness you're here.
Yeah, just for a minute. Just hanging up the Santa suit. For good.
But why?
Yeah, I made up my mind. Did I realize I'm no good at this job? Besides, I never wanted to be Santa in the first place.
You're Santa for like 1 month out of the year. I know, you know, I just like, this isn't the path or the career that I want to go down. Dude, it's a part-time job. It's not, you're not a full-time fucking Santa Claus. Big boy for the sub.
It's just too stressful.
Yeah, I hear you. I mean, what made you want to do it all these years?
For the kids. I know you can't make them all happy. The ones you do reach, ones that light up, and they tell you their dreams and what they want for Christmas. It's nothing like it, man. But seeing the...
Okay, this is a dub. That's not... Bro, somebody said that's creepy. How is that creepy? He's saying... Why are people saying Ayo? Bro's saying he does it to make the kids happy. How is that... Motherfucker said that's creepy. How the fuck is that creepy? Like, that's... He's being a mall Santa to kind of give kids creativity. Motherfucker's saying, oh, weird, ayo, what?
Those kids cry? Realize, I ain't cut out for this job. Take care, buddy.
Wait, Santa. I think I figured a way how we could make the kids happy again.
He still got the gifts in there. Bro's about to give them all back.
Okay, settle.
Hey! Ah. Did you bring us back to traumatize the kids all over again, huh?
No, oh my fucking god! Yo, somebody arrest this guy for fucking disturbing the peace. Oh my god, this man's just fucking running around fucking cursing people the fuck out. Yo, kick him the fuck out. What are you gonna tell my kid he's gonna get caught for Christmas again? Oh my fucking god. Yo, shut the fuck up.
That's not it. Please, just be patient.
Oh. Are you sure this is a good idea?
Just trust me.
Bro, somebody dropped that.
All right, I forgot why all the gifts were missing. Indeed, the Grinch did steal them. But good news is, Santa brought them back.
Thank you, Santa! Thank you, Santa!
Yay! Bro, this guy's bipolar. This dad is bipolar. Bro, for the love of God, somebody get this man checked. Holy shit, he just went from being blood-curdling mad to just being so joyous and happy because, oh, Santa brought back a fucking $4 gift for his fucking kid.
Oh, you're welcome.
Let's see what the gifts are.
Yes!
You know, I've been thinking, maybe you should have your own show.
Really?
Show?
Yeah, kids seem to really like you.
I don't know. I don't think I really want to do the whole main character thing. I'd rather be Santa's little helper.
Wow, I'm surprised. I thought you'd jump at that opportunity.
Yeah, I know, but as I say, the grass is always greener on the other side.
Charlie and I did try to convince him, and he was like, guys, it's
change, but for
find it, they look back and go, well, we already.
Bro, Darman has a podcast with Dixie D'Amelio on it.
Job that.
And
that,
fucking Mark. Why is Mark here?
That you have to work 40, 50. I like clothes and I look at them and I feel age and. Want
the cure
oh,
to talk
God,
about
the
this
vibe of this podcast is just so ugly though. Holy shit, dude, it's like a weird blue screen, these uncomfortable ass looking chairs where they're just sitting there awkwardly. You gotta have a more homey feel. But what the fuck, they're just sitting on like a stage in these modern ass fucking chairs. Oh my god, it's like a blue void. Yeah, literally. All right, we're going to skip that. I'm not watching that shit. Kiwi for the third best, big boy for the sub. I deadass, I will not tell my kids Santa isn't real because when they find out what? When they find out he's not real, they're going to throw a fit and be like, like, I don't know what to say. Bro, what are you talking about? who else would give presents to the kids other than Santa? What do the parents do it? It's a bit outlandish, don't you think? You think parents are like somehow concocting this scheme towards their kids? Why would they do that? What is this, like a nation worldwide thing? Parents are just telling their kids Santa's real when he's not? That makes no sense. Santa's obviously real. L, dude. Kiwi, what are you talking about, man? All right, we're moving on to the next video. Bro, I'm going to say that, though. That is a topic I have to tiptoe around because I don't know who the fuck is watching me, you know? But yeah. Nah, I just don't want to upset. Like, bro, if I said what y'all know I'm thinking right now, it's not that big of a deal, but I don't want to, on this offshoot chance, ruin this kid's day or some shit that's watching my stream. You know what I mean? All right. How to survive a nuclear apocalypse. Eric for the tier 3 sub dub. That is a massive tier 3, bro. I get like 3 of those a month. Thank you for the tier 3 sub. How to survive a nuclear apocalypse. We have a bunch of these videos that we're going to be watching today. We saw one the other day and it was just so stupid. Like, the issue with all of these videos is these are like almost unsurvivable encounters. And I understand it's, oh, how you're going to survive it. But he never gives a definitive. How the fuck am I going to survive a nuclear apocalypse? I'm dead. How to survive a grizzly bear attack? I'm dead. How to survive a tsunami? I'm dead. You're not surviving them. So, like, we're going to see what they say and whether or not it's actually a realistic way of them telling me how I'm going to live this. Pop for the 300 bets. Have you ever played the new Fortnite chapter yet? No, not yet. We might play it today. I don't know for sure, though. But that'll be after reactions. How to survive a nuclear apocalypse.
That doesn't sound good. You survived catastrophic disasters in previous episodes, like tsunamis.
Well, we haven't gotten to the tsunami video yet, so I don't know if we've survived the tsunami yet. So maybe we will. I don't know about that. You've survived tsunamis, earthquakes, World War III, a zombie apocalypse, the death of our star, the sun collapsing, Earth stopping rotating, living underwater. Like, bro, come on. What am I, surviving every single fucking thing that happens? What am I, goddamn immortal?
Landslides and hurricanes. But this time, the entire world is at stake. An all-out nuclear war has erupted.
I know we're doing the nuclear one first. I have no idea how this man's going to tell me to survive a tsunami. Tsunami waves are like 300 feet more. They're the size of skyscrapers, dude. Tsunamis are huge. Huge. And you're telling me I'm going to live that. Dude, they demolish everything.
Countries are launching attacks, and others are retaliating.
He says swim through it. Dude, this is what he's gonna say. How to survive a nuclear apocalypse. Just fucking tank that shit like Wolverine would. Just fucking tank that shit. Just fucking eat it. Just say, nope, I'm not dying to this, and continue on with your day.
Dude, to get
just
out
don't
of-
be a fucking pussy.
This world-ending scenario.
Literally, bro just showed the Wolverine clip. Here we go. Just hide in a manhole and just have regenerative skin. Have all your body parts heal like you're fucking superhuman.
Inside, because here's how to survive a nuclear apocalypse.
You don't. Video ends.
Right now, 9 countries are in possession of nuclear weapons.
Is it really only 9? I feel like more countries have nuclear bombs than 9. US,
Let's try and name them. U.S., North Korea, Russia, China, U.K., Japan? No. What the fuck? What countries have nukes? North Korea, Pakistan, Israel. Oh, it's way more than nine. This guy's fucking dead wrong. North Korea, India, China, Republic of South Africa, Ukraine, Brazil, Belarus, Australia, Belgium, Turkey, Iraq, Netherlands, Kazakhstan, Iran, France, U.S., Pakistan, Israel, Russia, U.K., Germany, Japan, Mexico, Republic of Korea, and the Philippines. Bro said nine countries. Yo, this was 2 years ago, but I don't think that many more countries got nukes in 2 years. And zombie for the 300 bits. I got sick recently and you are really cheering me up. Thank you. And I'm sorry that you're sick.
If any one of them launched even one of the almost 15,000 nuclear warheads in the world, it could cause a wave of chaos and destruction. A blast from a 1 megaton warhead would vaporize anything within 1 kilometer from its center. All of the buildings within 7 kilometers would collapse from a blast of air. Anything in a 12-kilometer radius would be hit by a thermal blast hot enough to cause third-degree burns. Ouch. And you better look away, because everything within 20 kilometers would be hit with a flash of light. It isn't too dangerous.
How the fuck am I gonna live through this? What is he gonna tell me to hide in a fridge? Like that dumbass movie scene? Hide in a lead-lined fridge, you'll be perfectly fine. Dude, what the fuck are you gonna say? How the hell am I... Bro's literally unfolding the scenario like, yeah, you're going to immediately be incinerated, right? You're going to see a flash of light and then you instantly die. Here's how you're going to get out of that situation. Maybe you just don't get hit by the nuke. That's the only fucking thing he could say.
But it could cause you to go blind for a few minutes. What should you do when you hear the sirens?
Say goodbye to my family. When I hear a nuclear siren, hug everybody and say, GG's, go next. GG's, unlucky. Unlucky, GG's, go next, right? Unlucky times 10, right? F.
Why would fleeing be a bad idea?
Why would fleeing be a bad idea? Bitch, that's the only thing I'm gonna try and do. I'm gonna be gassing that shit. I'm gonna be hopping my car, full floor in it, whatever direction I know that nuke ain't gonna be.
Could you survive the fallout? I know surviving a nuclear apocalypse may sound like a daunting...
You can't outrun a nuke? Well, it depends how long until it hits, right? How after the siren, if it hits in like 60 seconds, no shit, right? But if it's like a siren and it's like, everybody, the nuke is gonna hit us in a half hour, I would say, okay, I'm gonna grab my PC. I'm gonna grab my dog, right? Then I'm gonna hop in my Jeep Wrangler, and I'm gonna go off roading, bitch. I'm gonna grab my 4090, right? Because I'm gonna need that GPU, right? Because I just bought that shit. I'm not dipping on the GPU, right? I'm gonna get my dog. What about Brooke? Brooke will already be in the car. Okay, everybody, say yo. Stop acting like I forgot about my girlfriend. Yo, Brooke will already be in the car, bro. She's gonna be grabbing her own shit, right? Whatever the fuck. I'm gonna grab my Teddy Fresh beanie so I can film TikTok still. I'm gonna be getting my PC. I might grab Bob if I have some time. I'm gonna hop in the Jeep Wrangler. You know, doors off maybe. Might have to put the doors back on once the nuclear blast hits. And then I'm gonna be off-roading, right? That's the only way I live those. And even then, I'm probably dead. King Waltz! Bro said, give that pussy in the back a nice little smack. Do you mean Bob? King Waltz for the 10,000 biddies. God damn, Envoy for the sub garlic for the 300 bits. Just pour some water? What do you mean, just pour some water? Kiwi for the fucking 300 bits. Santa is real, I've learned, and I'm a changed woman. My apologies, I said dude. I just say dude to everybody, by the way. But, no. I'm glad you've came to the realization that Santa is real. Okay? Everybody knows Santa's real. It's so odd. Who would give the gifts?
Also, King Wolf, thank you for the 10,000 biddies. I'll give Bob a quick slap. Watch this. Weak? What do you mean weak? I slapped a fucking hat off him. Bro said weak. Kiss him? If I kissed Bob, would that be considered cheating on my girlfriend? If I kissed an inanimate object figurine named Bob? No. that's a raid. 4-inch for the 3-inch bets. What would happen if Macy's Day Parade Santa was assassinated? Dude, we're not going to get into that conversation again. We already had a whole talk about that. It would probably be devastating, right? Because if the Macy's Day Parade Santa got shot in the head, that would be all over the news for weeks, right? There would need to be a lot of convincing that he didn't die and that he's immortal or some shit and what didn't happen or some shit like that. It would be years, right?
Impossible task, but here's a few tips on how to get through the initial blasts and the aftermath.
Do you think anybody watches these videos, like, writing notes down, like, genuinely preparing for when this occurs? Gingy for the 400 bets. Like, genuinely worried about a nuclear apocalypse. They're just watching this fucking video, just waiting for this shit to happen.
Step one, hide. The sirens are blaring and everyone's in a panic. Better act fast, because you could only have a few minutes before impact. Your first instinct might be to evacuate and get as far away as possible. Hate your Monday morning commute? Well, imagine that, but much, much worse. The roads will likely be jammed with everyone trying to get out. This is a traffic jam that you wouldn't want to be caught in.
Bro, if I know a nuke is gonna fucking hit us, right? I might just walk outside, right? Like, I'm not trying to be that guy. Dude, okay, I survived the initial blast. Then what? I somehow, by fucking all means, the 0.01% chance I live through the blast. Everything is dead. I can't leave because the radiation, and I'm fucking trapped. Would I rather starve to death or instantly die by a nuke? I'm going to go for the latter right there because I think that, you know, both suck. But if I know I'm going to die, I'd rather fucking, you know, just get hit with the initial blast probably. B for the 300 bets. Yo, G full flavor should be Bart's lemon blast. We already did Bart berry blast. And your slogan should be, it's so sour it makes your ass pucker. I don't think G Fuel would let me have that as a slogan for my G Fuel flavor. It's so sour it makes your ass pucker. Yeah, I don't know about that one. Salty for the 300 bits. Can I get a little flex for getting a 96 on my stat exam? Small one. It's a channel point redemption.
You'll be a bunch
big
of
rats, though.
Sitting ducks, and you can probably picture the rest. Your best bet is to hunker down and find shelter.
Yeah, let me hide under a table. That'll really save me. Let me hide under a table. That'll prevent the nuclear bomb from incinerating my body.
If you or your neighbor have a bomb shelter, well, you don't need me to tell you where to go.
No shit.
If there are
dude, I don't got a bomb. Y'all got a bomb shelter? Somebody redeemed Flex. Y'all got a fucking bomb shelter straight for the 300 bets. If I see a nuke coming to America, I'm giving it one last
Underground subways nearby. Go there. They're some of the safest places to
Who the fuck has a bomb shelter? I ain't got no subway either. Bro, bomb shelter, subway. Otherwise, what the fuck do I do?
Stand an incoming nuke. But if there aren't any subways nearby, try to find the largest cement building. In the best case scenario, go to the basement. If it doesn't have one, get to the center of the building. Hiding in a building will help to shield you from the blast. Going
You're
as deep
dead
as you can.
Either way, dude. You're dead as shit.
You're dead as shit. Yo, stop redeeming Flex really hard. Please. Brian for the Fringe Bets. Have you ever seen the live-action One Piece? No, I haven't.
And underground will protect you when the radiation hits. Today is your lucky day. You find a basement to hide in. Everything around you violently shakes as you hear a deafening boom. You find your bearings and the rumbling settles. But don't leave just yet. It's still incredibly dangerous outside.
Yeah, for like weeks or months. And you're probably gonna starve to death.
Step two, wait it out. If you head out now, you'll be facing nerve-searing heat and a whole lot of fallout. In as little as 15 minutes, radioactive bits of dirt and debris will start to fall from the sky. Soon enough, everything outside will be covered in irradiated dust. Coming in contact with this stuff can quickly induce radiation poisoning, which is a terrible way to die.
Oh, nice. How am I going to prevent that? I got to buy a hazmat suit. I gotta get a bunch of water. I got to get, a green light to grow plants. At this point, I might as well just make a fucking bomb shelter with enough food for 5 years, dude. That's the only way you live through this.
Try to stay inside for at least 72 hours. After that, it will be safe for you to venture out.
No, it won't.
While you're in
there. No, it won't. Bro, he is dead. I feel like he's just dead wrong. 3 days after a nuke, after all the radiation is still on the ground, I can just walk outside. Yeah, okay.
There. Stockpile any packaged food, bottled water, and first aid supplies that were left inside the building.
Isn't Chernobyl still deathly unsafe for like the next fucking 50, 100,000 years or some shit? I know that was a nuclear reactor, but still. Like a nuclear bomb, I'm okay to go outside after 3 days? No, I'm not.
They'll not only help you get through these 3 days, but anything that
you've got animal crackers.
You have left over will be handy to help or trade with other survivors. Speaking of trading, you might try saving as much money as you can. You'll never know when you have to dig into your emergency funds.
Money? Money? No way this dickhead just said money. Once the nuclear bomb incinerates, I don't know, everyone, money is what, paper? At that point, I'd be using that for fire. What the fuck? Hey, I have a $100 bill here that you can't buy anything with because all the stores are fucking shut down. The government is shut down. Everyone's dead. Yeah, here's a $100 bill. I might as well wipe my ass with that $100 bill in this scenario. Bro just told me to save my money. Yeah, let me go get a piggy bank. Sponge for the sub.
For an apocalypse. The thing is, if a nuke causes society to collapse...
Okay, here we go. He's actually not stupid.
Your money will pretty much be useless.
Yeah, good shit. Good shit. Okay, he actually has a good fucking point.
But do you know what will stay the same while the dollar will lose its value?
Gold.
Gold.
This is a whole advertisement for me to buy gold. This is a buy gold ad. This is literally a buy gold ad. Oh my fucking God. Bros ranting and raving about gold again. Dude, I don't think, I understand gold will retain its value thousands of years into the future, right? Because it's a fucking minimal resource. But after a nuclear apocalypse, what the fuck am I gonna do with gold? I understand it's valuable, right? But in a scenario where I need, like, food, you trading me your fucking gold necklace is also meaningless. I don't give a shit about jewelry when I'm starving to death, right? Bro, just rant about gold.
If times are feeling a little unstable, it's a good idea to invest in precious metals. You'll be able to hold on to your wealth once society bounces back from the devastation.
Yeah, that shit ain't ever bouncing back, bro. If like 10 nukes hit Earth, society ain't bouncing back for the rest of our lives, at least. You ain't give a shit about gold then, right?
And who knows? Gold could be the most valuable resource during an apocalypse.
Now,
if you're in the market for a hedge against a nuclear apocalypse, you should head over to the sponsor of this video, jmbullion.com.
It's literally a gold ad. JM Bullion sells gold. This is literally, I was joking. I was actually joking. This is an entire advertisement for gold.
JM Bullion is an easy-to-use, discreet, and accredited physical...
No damn way he's promoting JM Bullion by saying that we need to buy gold for when the apocalypse hits.
...physical precious metals retailer. With over $4 billion in revenue and over 2 million orders shipped, JM Bullion is one of the largest, most respected online retailers of physical gold and silver products in the world. You turn on your phone to call for help, but the...
Bro! He actually just promoted gold. Or not promoted gold, promoted JM Bullion by saying we need gold to survive a nuke.
Internet and your phone service is knocked out. You can't stay here forever. It's time for you to explore this new radioactive world. Step 3. Look for information. You take a step outside. The world you once knew is now a wasteland. But don't stop and stare too long. Time is of the essence. The longer you're in contact with radioactive material, the more it will affect your body.
Yeah, and you're gonna die of radiation poisoning in like a day. Bro saying it's safe to go outside after 3 days when the dust settles. Dude, no it's not. You're still gonna die a day. Yeah, walk outside. You're gonna die a day later, Max.
Search nearby buildings for a radio.
You're fucking puking up your intestines. Not really, but you would fuck it. You would die.
It's crucial to get information in a time like this. You could find help, learn where the shelters are, or figure out if there will be any more attacks. The radio hisses.
Dude, if a nuke is about to hit Earth, I am driving my car through a Walmart. And I'm going to camp out at the Walmart, right? I'm going to gather a bunch of food. Then I'm going to hop back in my car at the Walmart. I'm going to leave the Walmart and find somewhere where the nuke didn't hit. Plan solved, right? Realistically, I'm probably going to die by the nuke's hit. But that's how you live, right? Because then my car won't be destroyed because it's protected by the Walmart. And then I'll be enclosed in it so I don't get fucking killed by the radiation either. I'd turn off the air. And I'd live in the little air that's in there for fucking 30 minutes while I drive out of the fucking nuclear site. Xeno for the fucking 5 gifteds.
Crackles. Dead air. Step 4. Search for others.
Bitch, I ain't give a shit about others in this fucking scenario. Oh my god. I'm keeping me and the other people I'm with alive. Search for others. You're bugging the fuck out. I'm getting out first. And then I'm gonna figure out what the fuck I'm gonna do.
Depend on world leaders to get through this. You're going to have to rely on yourself and the help of others. While you're searching the nearby buildings, call out for other survivors. You can get a lot more done with friends. And
bro, step 5, he's about to say, find somebody of the opposite sex. You might need to restart society. Find someone of the opposite sex of your own. You might need to fucking restart society in, like, an Adam and Eve sense after this. Like, bro, like they're the only two motherfuckers alive. Xenon for the 5 gifteds again. Thank you for the 5 gifted sub, Xenon. Big dubs for that. Tokachai for the 3. Imagine yourself snatching Brook tomato soup water in a radio. Dude, that's not... I'm not getting tomato soup. I'm gonna get, like, Ritz crackers or some shit. Fuck tomato soup.
You can work together to survive.
If you not think of the 5 gifted,
you find others and they're not so friendly. Try to make a trade. If you don't have anything to give, you could use your skills as currency.
Dude, if I'm in a nuclear apocalypse, I come upon other people that are alive and they're not friendly, I kill them, right? What do you mean try and make a trade? They're going to hold me hostage and take my shit. Yeah, here's where the gold comes in, chat, from JM Bullion. Here's where the gold comes in. Xenon for another 5 gifted subs. Thank you for the 5 gifted Xenon Savage for the 5 gifted subs. Big dubs for that. Thank them if you got a sub. And thank you for the 5 gifteds.
Step 5. Move. You collect a decent amount of supplies and make a friend or two. Now you should consider traveling somewhere with warmer temperatures. A large amount of the ash and soot from the blast will be injected into the stratosphere, potentially blocking out the sun. Working on your tan will be the least of your worries. Temperatures around the world could drastically drop. Move away from the north, where it'll reach freezing temperatures during the nuclear winter. You and your group of survivors journey safely to the south. Unfortunately, because of the irradiated land, you'll have to live off canned beans and tuna for the rest of your day.
What the fuck? Dude, he's planning out every exact... Oh, you're gonna have to live on canned beans and tuna for the rest of your days, dude. Or I just, find somewhere where the nuke didn't hit. Yeah, it's gonna block the sun, and that's gonna fucking ruin oxygen and plants and all that shit. You know, at that point, why the fuck would I want to live? At that point, why the fuck would I want to live? If life is absolute hell, and everyone's dead, and I'm in a nuclear hell where the earth is frozen over, and I have to fucking melt everything to be able to use it, and I have to live underground to fucking breathe and all this other shit. Oh, fuck no. Dude, why?
But you made it through.
Yo, fuck that. All right, now we're on to the grizzly bear one. This is going to be stupid as shit. How to survive a grizzly bear attack. Here we go. This one might be a little bit more realistic. Bring a 12-gauge shotgun. Boom, done.
Kim Wunderlich was out bow hunting when he found two bear cubs staring at him from just a few meters away, which meant their mother couldn't be far behind. Suddenly, the ferocious mom darted out the forest.
Oh, hell no! Oh, my God! Full-ass sprint at me. Dude, I don't know what I'm doing there. Yo, I understand they say play dead if you're a brown bear or some shit, bro. They're still ripping me the fuck up, right? They're gonna make sure I'm dead before they fucking back away.
And charged at Kim. The huge bear hit him so hard, they started rolling down the hill. Would he be crushed under the bear's body weight?
Yes.
Or would he survive long enough to fight it at the bottom of the hill? Here's how to survive a grizzly bear attack.
You don't.
Grizzly bears are North American...
They eat dead meat, so don't play dead. No, with brown bears, you're supposed to play dead. With black bears, you're not supposed to play dead. And I think you're supposed to, like, fight back and make yourself seem big. And then polar bears, you just die. I think polar bears will attack you no matter what. Yeah. That's what it is. Brown bears, you're supposed to play dead because they don't eat you, right? Brown bears don't want to eat you. The reason brown bears will attack you is out of, like, a protective scared purpose. So if you show you're vulnerable or dead or something that's not threatening to them, they'll leave you alone. That's, like, really the only way. Hi for the sub. Duck for the 300 bits. Came back from the Highland Life VOD. Needed to watch it just in case you play after. Reacts. By the way, those bears is what you said you could beat in a fist fight. Yeah, I know. I've retracted that statement since then. I used to say that I could kill a full-grown brown bear in a fist fight if I had a knife, right? Now, I don't know. I've seen a few videos people have sent through TikTok of brown bears fighting each other. They're massive. I don't think that I could probably take a bear in a fight with a knife. If I had a gun, yeah. But that's a gun, right?
Subspecies of brown bears. And it's scary that brown bear attacks are increasing all over the planet.
Bro, I don't know what I would do. Like, I really don't know what I would do. If I'm, like, riding my bike or some shit and I see a literal brown bear chasing me,
all over the planet,
I would try and climb a tree. But they can climb trees. And that's that. So then I'm fucked. Then I'm just sitting there until it decides to leave me alone.
Between 2000 and 2015, there were more than 660 attacks worldwide.
Holy
and
shit.
183 were in North America. This is why we put together a list of the top three most fantastic grizzly bear attack stories. And the lessons you can learn from them to survive if you face an angry 360-kilogram grizzly bear. How did one survivor endure two bear attacks in a row? Is playing...
Two bear attacks in a row. Oh, my God.
Dead a good strategy?
Would it play dead, get up, and then it immediately came back and started fucking beating the shit out of him again?
Just make you an easy kill. Number 3, the double attack.
Bro, is this all going to be on film?
It wasn't the hunting season in Montana yet, but the experienced hunter Todd Orr wanted to scout for elk. He was prepared and carried a pistol and bear spray. So when he stepped into a meadow and found a mother bear and her two cubs, and she started charging at him.
Oh my God, dude, they're fucking huge.
Quickly grabbed his bear spray, but it didn't stop her. She jumped on top of him.
Oh, you spray it with bear mace and then it doesn't work? You spray it with bear mace, it doesn't work? Okay, now I'll play dead. Bitch, you just made it angry. You just made it angry. Oh no. Dude, I don't think you playing dead at that point is going to fucking help.
And started biting his arms and shoulder. Todd laid face down, protecting his head and neck with his arms. When the bear was sure Todd wasn't a threat, she went back to her cubs and disappeared into the woods.
Bro.
Todd was injured, but he managed to go back to the trail and took the road back to his car. A few minutes later, he realized that he had taken the same path as the bears. And when the mama bear saw
him, oh, and they saw him again? Dude, I would be fucking so upset. Holy shit, you fucking survive a bear attack. You survive a bear attack, right? Then you get up like 10 minutes later and you're like, all right, I'm gonna go on with my day. And then you see the same damn bear that now knows that you weren't dead. And now you gotta redo the whole damn thing again. What are you gonna spray? You're gonna fucking play dead again. It's gonna leave you again. Why would it attack me? I feel like at that point it'd be like, okay, you're not a threat.
Him. She was really furious. She charged at him angrily.
Oh my God.
Todd repeated his strategy and played dead.
Well, this is
the bear
movie,
broke his arm and cut tendons in his forearm, but he remained calm. Finally, the beast left him for dead. This time, Todd waited longer before getting up and going to his car. He was seriously injured. But he managed to walk 4.5 kilometers to his car and drive 1 hour to the nearest hospital.
You pull up to the hospital? What happened? Oh, well, let me tell you how my day went. What happened? Okay, well, I have, oh boy, do I have a story for you. Well, two bears, actually.
Number 2.
Bro, I would be, if I was like a fucking person working at a hospital, some dude comes in, just told me he got mauled by a bear twice, and then had to walk 5 miles and fucking drove to the hospital.
Oh, Hunter. Do you remember Kim? The guy who was falling off a hill with a mother bear? They fell down a 20-meter hill. When they stopped, the bear bit him on the upper inner thigh. As an experienced hunter, he knew that he must remain still and calm. He didn't move until he heard the bear return to its cubs. He was seriously injured, but his friends managed to help him to the hospital and he survived.
Did his friends just fucking watch him get mauled by a bear? Luckily, his friends were there to take him to the hospital. Where the fuck were they when he was getting his ass kicked? Holy shit. Yo, okay, let's play out this scenario. You're with 3 of your friends, right? So 4 people. And a grizzly bear starts rushing one of your friends. Are you helping that friend? Or are you running away? So you could quadruple team the bear. Or are you dipping? Y'all all running. Y'all are all running. No damn way you're all leaving your friend to die. You're all leaving your friend to die. You're all leaving. Yo, I might do the same damn thing. Bro, throw stones at it. That's just going to get it aggroed on you. You ever play a fucking video game before? Yeah, let throw a stone at a bear while it's attacking your friend. Yeah, it's going to turn on you instead. Bro, at that point, if I run, I'd be like, play dead. Hopefully you don't die. See you later. I'll come back in 20 minutes or some shit like that. Or I'm helping the bear. Holy shit. Bro, that or you all gotta, like, scare the bear away. But I don't know if 4 people could theoretically scare a fucking 500-pound bear. Jow for the 300 bits. Have you seen the short video where the lady was skiing and in the shot you could see a bear chasing her down without realizing? Yeah, I've seen that.
Now, before we reveal our number one story, let's see what we...
Dude, you guys want to see that video? I feel like I could probably find that. The bear video. Bear chasing skiing skier. Dude, and they don't even notice. They're just listening to, like, music or some shit. Just vibing. Here it is. Bro, you hear it in the back? Bro, she's just going. Probably jamming out to some good fucking tunes. Bear in the back going. Fucking chasing her, bro. Oh, my God. It's probably good she didn't notice, because then she might have fell over and got scared. It gets close to her, too. I don't know how it's catching up to her. Holy shit! It's not real? Bro, are you telling me it's not real? Is it actually an unreal video? Bro, I've seen this video like 10 times. It might not be, because how the fuck would a bear chase them that fast? I can't tell. Does that look real? I mean, it's kicking up the snow. I feel like the sounds sound like they've been added after. You know what I mean? Nah, that's definitely real, bitch. Holy shit. That's real. Bro, they got it running up the hills and shit. It's been... No, it's proven... Oh, it's proven that it's fake? Bro, oh my God. That's some good-ass editing if that shit's fake. That dead-ass looks fucking real. Oh my God. It's clearly a grizzly hump. There's no grizzlies in Japan. How do they know they're in Japan? Okay, so it is fake. It is fake. Bro, that's some good-ass editing, though. Holy shit. Like, it looks like it's running up the hill and everything. Oh, my God.
We've learned so far. These two survivors were experienced hunters, and they knew the golden rule for surviving...
You have to draw a circle to survive? Like in SpongeBob? In SpongeBob, all you have to do... Yo, when the bear comes to attack you guys in the middle of the woods, all you gotta do is get a stick and draw a circle around you. And then you're good. Then you're good from the sea bears and shit, right? That's how you survive that.
Grizzly attack.
Oh, shit.
Play dead. Brown bears don't usually attack humans for food. They do it when they feel threatened or are starving.
Oh.
So you have...
How am I supposed to know which it is? Or starving? So it will eat me. So there's a good chance it will... Oh, that bear's looking a bit skinny. Maybe I shouldn't play dead for it. So if it feels threatened, it'll leave me alone, right? But if it's starving, me playing dead is only helping it kill me.
To convince the bear that you are not a threat.
Okay, even if I'm not a threat and it's starving, it's still gonna fucking kill me.
To play dead, stay in the fetal position to protect your organs. Cover your head with your...
Are they that big? Are bears deadass that big, dude? That's massive. Like, that guy's probably, like, 6 feet tall.
Protect your organs, cover your head with your arms, and be still. No matter how painful the attack is, stay down and still. When the bear leaves...
What if it bites my leg off? No matter how painful it is, I just have to be dead quiet. Yeah, just fucking... It starts ripping my fucking chest open. I just have to be just fucking slumped.
You'll need to stay down for up to 20 minutes, then leave in the opposite direction to the bear.
Bro, how am I supposed to know what way it fucking walked?
The people in our next story didn't know this rule. Number one, the saddest hike.
Oh, they get killed, don't they?
Brian and Marilyn Matayoshi were hiking in Yellowstone National Park when they saw a mother bear with her two cubs. They stopped to take some pictures and decided to keep hiking.
See, that's a tiny bear. Is that a cub?
Some minutes later, they found the bears again.
Like, I could fight that one to the death, right? Like, it, I think I don't think that bear would kill me, right? Even if it's mad and angry and it stands up, I think that one I could solo in a fight. But that bear's probably also, like, 1 year old. Like, that bear is tiny.
Hiking. Some minutes later, they found the bears again. This time, the mom started following them.
Yeah, see, I didn't know about that one, though.
Brian panicked and told his wife to run. They only ran about 155 meters before the bear reached Brian. Marilyn jumped behind a fallen trunk. She heard the bear mauling her husband, but she...
Bro! This is a real story? This sounds awful!
She stayed still on the ground. After it killed Brian, the bear went to Marilyn. She remained still, so the bear left. Marilyn escaped with no serious injuries.
You have to sit there dead still while it murders your husband. You're just sitting there. It's fucking... And your husband's screaming while he's getting his fucking lungs ripped out and his face clawed in and he's getting bit. And you're just sitting there just...
But Brian didn't survive.
Rip. Literally.
Grizzly bears are amazing and scary creatures. But if you stay calm and don't look like a threat, you can survive an encounter.
Nah, they're
but
big as
not
shit.
Not all bears are like that. For polar bears, almost everything is prey. Can you imagine surviving a polar bear attack?
No! For a polar bear, it'll kill anything. Bro, hell no. But polar bear cubs are so cute. But polar bear cubs are so cute, though. Aww. 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 You're telling me he's going to rip my face off? Aww. Aww. Yeah, he probably would. In like a year or two after that. Bro, polar bears, even polar bears themselves are pretty cute, bro. Aw, they're so tiny. They're like the tiniest bears, but they... Aw. Aw. But it'll kill me. It would rip my face off. Look at it. Look at it. So, aw. Aw. You're saying that? I'm getting my face fucking clawed in. The polar bear is actually just ripping my body apart. The whole time, I'm just like, aww. Aww. you're so cute, though. Aww. Wait. Somebody said look up Kodiak bear. Bro, fuck no, dude. How big are they? Kodiak bear weight. A Kodiak bear can weigh up to 1,500 pounds. Bro, polar bears are bigger than that? Bro, I thought polar bears were the tiniest ones. No. No. Polar bears can weigh up to 1,000 pounds. Holy shit. Holy shit, dude. Oh my god. Look at that. Look at that. Bro, that's probably a 6 foot tall man. Oh my god, that thing's like 8 feet fucking tall. Dude, I'd shit myself. Well, I'm never going to Antarctica, so I don't think I'm gonna ever see a polar bear. But, yeah. Nevertheless, that shit's scary. Alright, I gotta take a piss real quick. We're gonna play some Christmas tunes, then we'll go to the next one. Hold up. Ella for the 300 bits. I go to LSU and we have a live tiger on campus. Where does it live? Do they have, like, a housing unit for it or some shit? How the fuck does that work? All right, hold on. Count me down 30
I had to post on TikTok. Hold on. All right, next video. That was longer than 30 seconds. I'm always longer than 30 seconds. I always just tell my chat it's 30 seconds. Hold up. How to survive. I just clicked off the video. All right, we're on the last how to survive video. This one's only 4 minutes. Probably because he can't say much about how to survive a fucking tsunami.
You're on a beach. Not a worry in the
world. Is this the same guy?
World. The sun bronzing your skin, sand trickling between your toes, the sound of waves.
Most replayed.
Skin, sand trickling between your toes, the sound of world. The sun bronzing your skin, sand trickling between your toes, the sound of world. The sun bronzing your skin, sand trickling between your toes. The sand in the world. The sun bronzing your skin, sand trickling between your toes. Worry in the world. The sun bronzing your skin, sand trickling between your toes. The sound of waves.
Alright, I'm done.
Wait, what? Where did all the water go? Did you see it going out? Better act quickly. In a matter of minutes, you may be underwater. Here's how to survive a tsunami, according to science. Tsunamis are triggered by intense under...
If I'm on the beach and a tsunami is coming my way, I'm dead. Like I'm dead. Where the fuck am I going to go in time to not get hit by a fucking 400-foot wave?
Underwater activity, usually an earthquake or an underwater volcanic eruption. These events displace huge volumes of water, pushing it up from the ocean's floor to its surface. But when gravity pulls it back down, all this built-up energy is released outwards, forming deadly waves that grow stronger as they ripple across the ocean.
Holy
shit. A tsunami's waves can be 100 kilometers long and sometimes taller than 30 meters. They can travel across whole oceans, moving...
Taller than 30 meters. That's... How tall is that? That 30 meters is fucking what? 100-something feet? Like, you're not living that.
At the speed of a
they
jet.
They can be way bigger than that, too. Biggest tsunami. Tsunami height. The highest tsunami was 1,700 feet tall. In 1958, there was a tsunami triggered by a landslide on the narrow bay of Alaska's coast. It was 1,700 feet tall. What's like a notable building? What's like a high building? The Eiffel Tower. The Eiffel Tower is 1,000 feet. It's two Eiffel Towers. The Empire State Building. Empire State height. The Empire State Building is 1,454 feet to the tip. So it's that wave. Was taller than the Eiffel, or not than the Eiffel Tower, than the Empire State Building. Imagine that wave just moving fucking so fast at you. You're not living that. I know most of them are like 100, 200 feet, but still, that's tall as shit. Reverb for the fire shits. My zoo in Alaska has a polar bear in it. It's huge as hell, but very beautiful. Dude, I always want to, I really want to visit Alaska. Do you live in Alaska? Star for the 300 bits. I walked outside once. I had an 8-foot-tall bear going through my neighbor's trash, stood up and stared at me, and I just walked back inside. Yeah, I would have done the same damn thing. Dude, what if it starts trying to break into your house, though? You got, like, a sliding glass door or some shit. It just starts fucking crashing. It starts punching it. Oh, no.
Airplane. So with such speed, strength, and stamina, how does anyone stand a chance?
I used to always say, why don't people just swim through a tsunami? But tsunamis move very fast, right? Tsunami speed. Like, you would get tumbled. Tsunami speed average. The average tsunami is 500 miles per hour.
What the fuck, dude? That is that why he mentioned a plane? Dude, should we watch a video of a tsunami? Tsunami video. Because all the ones that he's showing are like animated. The biggest tsunamis caught on camera. Dude, 500 miles an hour. That's why you're not swimming through it. The second it hits you, you get crushed. Well, Joe, that's why I go like this. Well, Joe, that's why I go like this. Well, Joe, yes, the wave is fast. That's why I go like I'm diving into the water. Jonathan! For the fucking 25 gifted! Jonathan22225 for the 25 gifted subs. How many do you have to the fucking channel, dude? Holy shit. 160 subs to the channel total. 25 today from fucking Jonathan22225. Thank you for the 25 gifted. Thank them if you got a sub from them. And thank you for the 25 gifted subs. Thank you. Genuinely, just gave 25 subs to my chatters. Very helpful to the channel. Thank you very much for the 25 gifted, Jonathan. Big dubs in the chat for Jonathan. Thank you. Genuinely. My shit is tangled out the ass. Holy fuck. Hold up. I literally can't. Okay. There we go. Oh, all right. Did he give more? Wait, did he give more? It was again! Oh my god! Bro! Jonathan for the fucking 50 gifteds. Dude, I looked up after trying to fix that shit. And I saw it again. I was like, oh, maybe I'm just reading the same damn thing. Thank you for the 25 gifteds again. 50 fucking gifted subs this stream. Now we're at 144 subs. Oh my god! Thank you, Airplane, for the sub. Jonathan, bro, thank you for the 25 gifteds. Genuinely. I'm going to see if they said anything. Hold up. Jonathan, thank you for the subs. Where the fuck is your username? User Jonathan. How the fuck is there no user that matches that info? What the fuck? Jonathan 22225. Oh, there you are. Oh, on December 3rd, they said Mr. Beast is going to be in the next chapter of Fortnite. Okay, so they didn't say anything today. Dude, thank you for the fucking 50 gifteds. Actually, dub in the chat for Jonathan. Thank them if you got a sub from them, because Jonathan just gave out 50 fucking free gifteds for you guys. TR Roden for the sub, or T Roden for the sub. And thank you for the 50 gifted subs to my channel. I actually appreciate it so much. Helps me out, helps the channel out, helps my chat out. I thank you very much for the subs. The big boy for the 300 bets. Have you played Food Truck Sim yet? No, I have not. They have a bunch of iffy reviews, so I've kind of been on edge on whether or not I'm going to play that game. The Steezy for the sub. New Mr. Beast video out. Oh, my fucking god. Y'all cap to me every fucking time. Bro, he just uploaded. He didn't upload again. Yeah, you're all a bunch of liars. I think you meant the skin is out. Kaden for the sub. And Jonathan, again, thank you for the 50 gifteds, dude. Girl interrupted for the 300 bets. I remember there was a tsunami warning in SD. Also, it snowed here, which is insane because it only snows in the mountains. What is SD? South Dakota? Is that South Dakota? How the fuck would you have a tsunami warning in South Dakota? All right, here's videos of tsunamis. Bro, why are they watching it? Yo! Bro! Holy shit. Thank you for the fucking 25 gifteds, Jonathan. Oh my god. Oh my fucking god, dude. Hold up. Let me write something down. Hold up. I just came up with a video idea. Bro, thank you for the fucking 25 gifteds, Jonathan. 75 gifteds total to this fucking stream today alone. I don't know. Oh, somebody's spamming the N-word. Can we ban them? Yep, thank you. Thank you, mods. Yo, L Chatter, by the way, not to Jonathan. L Chatter to the kid that was spamming the N-word. Fuck you. Jonathan, thank you for the 75 gifteds. Jonathan22225, thank them if you got a sub, but thank you for the fucking 75 gifteds, dude. Actually, W Chatter, I thank you very much for helping out the channel. Why are they standing there waiting? This ain't no damn tsunami. That's a tsunami. See, now that's a tsunami. Bro, they're in the inland and shit's getting fucking wiped out. It's moving cars. Bro, I hate how they're all low quality as shit. What's the wave? I can't even see where the wave is. Oh, there's the boat. We gotta see the boat go over it. Oh my god, it just crushed the boat. Bro, imagine trying to ride that shit. Oh, that boat's going down, bitch. Oh, that boat's going down. Oh, GG's. Oh, GG's. I don't even see the boat anymore. Oh, yeah, that shit sunk. Oh, they're all dead in there if there's people in that. Bro, I feel like those aren't even that big, though. Japan tsunami.
Put seawall, but rave in as far as in moving as fast.
Bro, like, you, because no one ever records it, because you got to get the fuck out of there. Biggest waves in history.
If there is one natural disaster, and feet were uprooted.
All right, now we're going to go back to the video. Bro, Jonathan. One more time. Jonathan. The fucking 100 gifted subs this stream, man. Hold up.
Jonathan. Jonathan. Thank you for the gifted subs, man. Thank you. Jonathan, big doves in the chat for Jonathan here.
The fucking peaking.
Jonathan for the 25 gifteds, 4 times in a row, which would equate to 100 subs this stream alone. Thank you, Jonathan, for the fucking subs. I appreciate it very much. Ah! Jonathan, thank you for the fucking 100 gifteds.
Should I just do a stream where I breathe into the mic like this? Jonathan, thank you for the 100. I gotta stop. Jonathan, thank you for the 100 gifted subs. Holy fucking shit. Juice for the sub. The big boy for the 30 minutes. Have you seen Black Adam yet? And was it good? I have not seen it yet. So I don't know if it was good. But thank you for the 100 gifted subs. This stream, Jonathan, big dubs. All right.
In a tsunami hazard zone, you can still survive if you know what to do. The first step to survival is to be able to identify the early signs of a tsunami. The Pacific Ocean is home to volatile tectonic activity, which explains why 75% of the world's volcanoes...
Wait, a tsunami can hit New Jersey?
...is home to volatile...
Oh, no, good shit. I thought this was the U.S. This is the U.S. It can only hit California. Good shit.
...tectonic activity.
Yep, New Jersey, yep. We only get hurricanes, yep.
Which explains why 75% of the world's volcanic eruptions and 90% of the world's earthquakes occur in the Pacific.
Yeah, I learned that in oceanography. But I might have failed the shit out of my final. I don't think I did. I think I probably got like a low B. Little Italy for the sub. Dude, that's all we learned about in oceanography. That was the only cool thing that I actually learned in oceanography. In a fucking entire semester of that dumbass college class, was that, like, the Pacific Ocean is, like, a death land for, like, everything, just because of how everything falls tectonic plate-wise. Being on the East Coast is usually much more, like, survivable in terms of, like, what hits that shit. other than like hurricanes and stuff. Little Italy for the sub. Mason for the Thringe Bits. Says Merry Rizmas to all. Pop for the three. What the freak? I'm in California. Well, I doubt a tsunami is going to hit California soon. Reverb for the 580 bits. You missed my last bits, but it was in the mask gifted, so it's all good. I'll go look. Reverb. I'll play this while I'm looking.
These geological disturbances are the reason why 80...
Yeah, I'm in Anchorage, and this winter we had the largest amount of snowfall. Dude, what time is it in Alaska? Jonathan, for the 10 fucking gifteds, dude. Dude, you don't have to gift this many subs. You have gifted... Dude, now bro has gifted 245 subs to the channel. Bro's on the fucking top 10 gifters list now. You're zombie for the sub. Thank you for the 10 gifteds, Jonathan. Welcome to the top 10 gifters list. Thank you for the 245 gifted subs total. That's fucking insane. Oh my god. Thank you. Literally.
5% of all tsunamis happen in the Pacific Ocean. In most cases, an earthquake comes before a tsunami. So, if you're near the coast and you experience an earthquake, protect yourself from that first. But once the shaking stops, move to higher ground as quickly as possible. The beach.
Yeah, but then I'm going to look like a dumbass if I move to higher ground and there isn't a tsunami. An earthquake happens. I just start running up the Hollywood Hills. My friends are like, where are you going? What the fuck are you doing? There's a tsunami! There's a... How to Survive YouTube channel told me I need to run uphill. I'm going up there because they said that after an earthquake, there's probably going to be a tsunami. And I'm just trying to make sure. Now, I'm going to fucking check the news and they're going to tell me if a tsunami is going to hit. The fuck?
Beach will grow bigger. Run the other way. An early sign of an impending tsunami is that the water along the coast will recede. It pulls back and exposes the seafloor. Do not go to the beach to investigate.
Oh, but that would be so cool to investigate. It pulls back the sea floor like fucking a mile back. Would y'all go investigate?
Pulls back and exposes the sea floor.
That'd be so cool to fucking see what the fuck is in the ocean. You know what I mean? Like you could literally walk out like where you wouldn't be able to swim. It's like 20 feet deep.
Or do not go to the beach to investigate. You'll only be putting yourself at risk for when the water surges back.
Yeah, now I hit him with one of these. I get a nose plug. I go... And then I hold my breath. That shit ain't working.
Instead, head in the opposite direction. Try to get as far as 3.5 kilometers from the ocean... or 30 meters above sea level to ensure your safety. Get to the highest elevation possible.
How the fuck, if I'm on the beach and I see the water receding, I got about like a minute, right? Or like however long, I don't know how much time I have, but tsunamis move fast as shit. I don't got that much time. You're telling me I see the water receding on the beach. I now have to move 3 miles or 3.5 kilometers. Like, out into the fucking inland? How the fuck am I gonna get there that fast?
Tsunamis travel quickly, and you may not have enough time to clear the hazard zone. In this case, look for a tall building with a sturdy concrete foundation.
Oh no.
If you see one nearby, run inside and get to the roof as quickly as possible.
Yeah, and then if the building gets knocked over, you just kind of pull like an MLG water bucket, you know what I mean? And you just kind of jump into the tsunami wave, and then you'll live, right? Unless there's, like, cars tumbling around, then you might kind of get, like, impaled.
If you can't make it to a building in time, your best bet is to grab onto something and hold on. Though that might not sound very practical,
that sounds
hold
dumb
the
eye as
roll
shit.
For a moment. In the 2004 Indian Ocean tsunami, an Indonesian woman was finally rescued after holding onto a palm tree for 5 days straight. While it isn't ideal...
How long was the fucking current going? 5 days? 5 days? I thought it was one big wave. What do you mean 5 days? Oh, she was probably stranded in the aftermath of the water flooding, but like, dude, 5 days?
If you can't get to higher ground in time, you need to find something to hold on to. As the tsunami moves inland, it will sweep tons of debris along with it. This can be very dangerous as the accumulation of debris traveling at high speeds becomes...
Yeah, and I'm holding... Yo, let's pan this out. I hold on to the palm tree. Number one, the wave's going to fucking crash into me. The tree might fall over, right? Say the tree doesn't fall over. I'm holding on to this palm tree, and this fucking big-ass metal crate just crushes me. Just genuinely crushes my body.
Traveling at high speeds.
That's going like 50 miles an hour.
Become fatal obstacles for anyone who's caught in the current. However, many tsunami victims have been saved by climbing on to detached roofs or holding on tightly to floating cars or other large objects.
Oh my God.
Of course, if you've made it this far, your troubles aren't over yet. A tsunami isn't one wave, but a series of waves known as a tsunami wave train.
I thought it was one wave. Oh God, GG's, my fucking diving plan. I'm gonna have to keep going. For how long? How long does that fucking shit last? The big boy from Thridge Mets, what's your take on Colorado? Never been there. Step bro and water for the sub Arsenal for the Thridge Mets. Such a bait tsunami scene, it's fucking insane. Bait tsunami scene. The fuck is that? Bait tsunami scene. Hold up. Bro, this is a movie. This isn't a real scene. Not gonna lie, I feel like it should be a requirement to learn how to swim. Well, it depends. Like, realistically, most people that, obviously, everybody that lives on the coast, does anybody here not know how to swim? Let me open it up with that. Do you know how to swim, yes or no? Why are people saying TOS? How is this TOS? Like, I feel like if you know, if a lot of people don't know how to swim, most people that don't know how to swim don't live near the ocean, right? Most people that don't know how to swim live in, like, Montana, Wyoming, Utah. Like, even if there's lakes near them, like, people that tend to live, not like, by the ocean know how to swim at much higher rates, right? Like, I don't actually know how many people don't know how to swim in, like, Montana. I'm gonna see if, like, this actually shows up. How many people don't know how to swim? In U.S. It might have a... 1 in 5 Americans don't know how to swim. Wow. It's just like you've never been at a pool? Like, I just feel like that's... I know I'm from New Jersey, but it's just like, dude, like, not 1 in 5 people don't know how to swim. Like, that's, dude, that's, there's guaranteed, like, more than 100 people in my chat that don't know how to swim. Like, what, I feel, it also might be older populations, but, like, dude, 1 in 5 people don't know how to swim. That's nuts. Wow. Just because I feel like it doesn't even take that long to learn how to swim, either. Like, how long does it take to learn how to swim? Like, a day? It is kind of scary, though, if you've never... I know people that don't know how to swim. How many people can't swim UK? Somebody said to look up UK. 1 in 5 in England, same. 1 in 5 in the US and 1 in 5 in England cannot swim. Wow. I feel like that's worse for the UK, seeing that isn't the UK literally like an island?
Waves,
not an island, but it's entirely surrounded by water.
Maybe anywhere from 5 minutes apart to an hour apart. And be aware that the first wave that hits isn't always the strongest.
A few weeks to master, but like you could theoretically learn how to tread water in like a day if you tried. Or not tried, but you need somebody to teach you. Watch the video of the guy watching paint dry. What? The big boy for the Thridge Mets. What do you mean watch? I'm not watching a video. What do you mean the video? Like if you sent it in the Discord, I don't see it right now. Again, !! Discord, join the Discord, send videos for me to react to in the video suggestion tab. If you're already in it, just hit the video suggestion tab. You can send videos to react to.
Even when you think it's over, stay where you're safe until you hear from local officials. It goes without saying, tsunamis are terrifying. And when a 30-meter wave is hurtling towards you at 800 kilometers per hour, you're probably feeling pretty helpless.
Yo, I don't know what the fuck this dad's doing. It ain't looking good. It ain't. Let me just say, it ain't looking good for this dad and his kid. Let me just say, I don't think they're
at 800.
They stayed on the beach a bit too long.
Kilometers per hour. You're probably feeling.
Yeah, I'm gonna outrun this shit. No, you ain't. Fucking no, you ain't. No, you ain't. This shit is over. Over. That shit is not looking good. Grass fed for the sub. These people survived being swallowed by a whale. What the fuck is that? All right, we're done with the how to survive videos for today. Next video, streamer gets angry and makes horrible apology video. This is a Charlie video. Yo, do we crack a G Fuel? Do I have any of his? I drank all of his. I would say it would only be right to drink a Charlie G Fuel watching a Charlie video. We'll have a clickbait. We'll have a clickbait. Tried and true. Tried and true clickbait. 30% off this month. Code Joe B! Exclamation point G Fuel. There's also a sale this weekend for a lot of flavors or a lot of tubs. Can I actually... you guys want to see? You guys don't want to see. I'm going to show you anyway. This is. I am sponsored by G Fuel, but I am helping you guys if you do want to save money. Just if you want to wait. If you're going to use my code, wait until literally this weekend and then buy any of these tubs with my code. If you use... Okay. This is a last-minute sale. Friday through Monday, all of these tubs are, like, I think $8 off, and then you can also use my code. And then, so, like, if you use my code on this, a tub of G Fuel would be $20 when it's normally $36. And here it would be, like, what, $15 when it's normally $30 or some shit. So you would actually save, like, almost 50%, around 50% if you use my code there. But that's just this weekend. And they also have a BOGO going on. So, exclamation point G Fuel, code Joe B, 30% off this month. NBD for the sub.
Right now, there's a Twitch streamer getting tomatoes thrown at him all across Twitter for a clip that's going viral of him having an embarrassing and horrible response to one of his community members answering a question that he asked them.
In Spanish, and it's chef's kiss. All right. Kirby, where the fuck have you been? Oh my god, well tell you what, Miss Dirty Curvy, you know what we're not gonna do? We're not gonna talk about it in my chat.
Bro said, well, my mom died. Well, we're not gonna talk about it in my chat. That's a fucking vibe killer.
Because it's Friday, and that is a whole big bucket of bummer.
And his response is a big barrel of butt cheeks. So to give context to this situation here on the lore...
Bro, this is going to be my take initially off of this. That guy's a dickhead, right? But, like, I will say, and Charlie's probably going to go in on this because this is a 15-minute video. Chatters shouldn't just go into a chat and just start ranting about, oh, I failed this test today. Oh, I did this. Oh, I did that. But, like, if a chatter's going to come to me and say, like, hey, my mom died. I've been in kind of a bad mood. Your streams have been helping me out. Thanks. Why are you going to be a dick? And
he fucking asked. He fucking asked.
If you're going to ask, that'd be like, hey, yo, Manifest. Why haven't you been in my stream? One of my active chatters, Manifest. Or 2inch. Why haven't you been in my stream? Well, my mom died. Ooh, what a vibe killer. Like, you don't fucking say that. You fucking asked them. Oh my god, they're not just oversharing, and even if they were, you're still being a dick. The big boy for the 300 bits. Everyone in my town doesn't know how to swim. How? You probably live in, like, a more non-water surrounded area.
This was a regular viewer of this streamer, an avid supporter who had taken a bit of a hiatus and was unfortunately going through a very hard time with her mother passing. So when he saw that she was back, he asked her, oh, where have you been? To which she just answered honestly, her mother had passed away. So, you know, it was a bit of a tough time. That's why she was taking a break. And then for some reason, this must have input a cheat code into the streamer's brain that just sent him into, like, debate club. He, for some reason, then just goes into, like, this TED talk about how you shouldn't answer his question if your answer is something sad because it brings down the vibes of the stream. It's baffling because you had asked her and she just answered your question honestly. I'll play a bit more of the clip before getting into it, but I want to make it clear early on that I understand a lot of streamers have a similar perspective where you don't really want someone in chat that's just talking about like a really traumatic experience they're going through, because it's not really the place for it and the streamer's not the therapist. Like, I do get...
That's true, but you asked. And, like, dude, if people come to my chat, like, there's people that come and they, like, come to my chat and they say they're, like, they're suicidal or something. Yeah, I'm not going to be able to help every individual scenario. But, like, I'm not going to be a dick and be like, you're a vibe killer. You're a vibe killer. Please don't kill the vibe. It's Thursday. It's a vibe day. Like, I'm not going to be like a fucking asshat like that. That's just like dickhead shit. And, like, that's more serious shit. The only time I would really be like, oh, you're killing the vibe is if, like, some dickhead was like just every day, just like, well, here's how my day went. And then they gave me a whole ass fucking 5-paragraph fucking scenario on how their day went. Like, I don't give a shit about that, right? But if you're going through something serious and you type it in my chat, like, yeah, I don't want you to just randomly start dumping everything that's going on in your life. But if a streamer asks what happened or you're, like, asking for advice, that's perfectly fine, right? Now, overdoing it, like, I have had people, like, a year back, this one kid every day would come into my chat and tell me he was going to kill himself. And every day for, like, and my mods remember this, my OG mods. It was like every day he would come into my chat and I would talk him down, right? And I would be like, okay, you got to go seek help. He would say, okay, I'm going to go seek help. He wouldn't seek help. He would come back and tell me the same damn thing every fucking day, right? Like, at that point, I can't help you anymore. You're just repeatedly saying the same thing. But when a streamer or when a chatter comes to a streamer for advice, just give them advice. Even if you don't have to, like, you don't have to fucking sit there on the whole ass page. Like, if I don't know what I should give for advice, I'll say I don't know, right? But I'm not going to be like, oh, you killed the vibe. I'm just going to be like, bro, I really don't know. I'm sorry that you're going through that. I've said that before because sometimes I don't know what to say. But, like, him literally asking and then being a dick when they gave a response, like, you're a cuck.
Get that perspective. But there's a difference between, like, just a random person treating Twitch chat like it's their
side. What if that kid actually killed himself? I mean, I don't know, but, like, what I say to people, that, like, that's not my fault, even if that, I don't think that occurred. But what I'm saying is when that chatter came into my chat and they were suicidal and I helped them for, like, 3 days in a row and they just kept not listening to me, like, eventually I'm just like, dude, I don't know what you want me to. Eventually I literally said, I can't help you anymore, right? Like, I tried to help him. I gave him advice. If you're not going to listen to me, you're not going to listen to me. Like, that's not my fault. There's a clip of it on YouTube of me helping this kid. And then, like, days later, he just kept... The other clips aren't there, but, like, days later, he just kept saying the same thing. Like, eventually, I'm going to be like, bro, what do you... Like, I don't know what else I could say.
Psychiatrist, and you asking someone a question and them answering honestly, especially when it's a member of the community that you already...
Like, if I didn't help... Or if I didn't say anything or I was a dick, like, that'd be my fault. But, like, when I've given him advice multiple times and they keep coming back saying the same thing, eventually I'm going to be like, bro, I can't do anything. Even today, when people come into my chat and they're suicidal, I'll say to them, like, I'll give them my whole, like, rant about, like, life and, like, why I think life is meaningful and, like, just trying to help them, like, kind of get through that initial, like, this sucks, you know what I mean? Or that suicidalness, but then I have to transfer it and say, go get help, right? Because if somebody comes to my chat suicidal, I can't help you at the end of the day. I'm not a fucking psychiatrist. I'm not a therapist. I could give you advice, but more than that, I can't. And so when somebody keeps coming back and they keep repeating the same thing, eventually I just say, bro, I don't know what to do. But with this guy, he's just an asshat.
Kind of no to us.
ADS for the 1001 bits. Are you ever going to make mod apps again? Probably not. I probably will mod some people soon. I'm probably going to mod Manifest in a bit. Pig Memento. There's a few VIPs that need to get mod soon. The Batman for the sub. One Bailey for the sub. Two inch isn't in contention for mod yet, but 2 inch has been a better chatter, admittedly. W2 inch, he has been a better chatter. I might VIP 2 inch in the near future. Not today, but 2 inch may. I always said he would never get it back, but 2 inch has been a better chatter. Reverb for the 500 bits. No promo, shout out for the holiday times. Honey is free and finds you coupons when you shop. True. I'm not sponsored by Honey though. Finn for the sub to Big Boy for the Fringe Bets. Oh, says I live in Florida. Really? Half of the people you know in Florida can't swim? Wow. Grass fed and MBD for the sub.
a certain level. I don't understand why you're all of a sudden getting mad at them for answering that.
And I'm sorry for your loss, but we're not doing that in my fucking chat. Thank you. Well, okay, Miss Dirty Kirby, you said, no, that's fine. You asked, so I told. No, I didn't ask you to tell me the biggest fucking bummer news in the world. I said, hey, what's up? How are you? You know what? Let me give you a little bit of a lesson, Miss Nerdy Kirby.
Oh! 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 Dude, why are you being such an ass? Bro, like, it was bad when he left it like that, but he could have just left it like that, and then he could have said, oh, yeah, it was a joke. He kept going in and saying, oh, okay, here's what you're going to do, and then he talks to them like that. Like, I've gone off on my chat. But I go off on my chat when y'all are a bunch of dicks. Like, at my gingerbread stream. When I was on my gingerbread stream and y'all kept spamming out the ass that my mic quality was bad, I fucking started screaming because I got pissed, right? Because y'all were just pissing me the fuck off. But, like, dude, with this, yeah, and the mic wasn't even that bad. And so that's why I started fucking screaming. But with this shit, like, bro, like, you're just going off on them when they did nothing wrong. One Bailey for the sub, Gamer for the sub. Your mic quality was bad. Yeah, but I was still trying to do a nice-ass event for my chat. I spent, like, 30 minutes trying to fix the lavalier mic. And then for 10 minutes straight, y'all just spammed that the mic was bad. So, yeah, I fucking went off. But, like, that's different than literally somebody saying, oh, my mom died, and you looking at the camera and giving them a talk on how they're a vibe killer.
When something really, really bad is going on in your life, and in a public forum, someone asks you, hey, what's up? How are you? There are two acceptable responses. Good, and you know what? I'll make it through. That's it.
So you want to just...
Yeah, but that prevents people from sharing how they feel. You know what I mean? I don't think... Yeah, I would agree that, like, you're not supposed to just go on a public forum and just start dumping shit. But you fucking asked. You fucking asked. Don't ask if you don't want an answer unless it's one of two answers. Like, the fuck? Like, yeah, they shouldn't just go on, like, a fucking random page on TikTok and start spamming about their life or some shit. But, like, dude, you asked.
Talk to NPCs that only have two dialogue options, okay? Then why bother trying to communicate with a human being? Like, okay, give them a script.
Big Tom for the 300 bits. Missed most of the stream. What happened to High on Life? High on Life I played yesterday. I didn't say I was going to complete it today. I might play it after Reacts today. Also, can we do that poll? What game do you guys want me to play after Reacts? What game? There's three options for today. Fortnite, Valorant, and continuing High on Life, which is the funny Rick and Morty game. Oh, my God. I'll let you guys vote. We'll probably do, like, one or two polls for, like, we'll do, like, the top two. Okay, y'all are all voting High on Life. Yeah. I'm gonna play for, okay, if I don't play Fort or Val, okay, everybody's voting High on Life. Holy shit. Okay, well, if I don't play Fort or Val today, I will for the next coming weeks. I'm definitely gonna be doing a Christmas Fortnite-esque stream because I love the Christmas vibe of Fortnite. So we definitely will. I haven't played the new chapter yet since the event. Corey for the sub. So we will try it out. And Valorant, I play whenever. I haven't played Valorant on my new PC on stream yet, but I will definitely do that in the future as well. High on Life, I'm assuming most people are voting for just because I haven't. I literally played that yesterday and we haven't finished it. We wouldn't be able to finish it today either, but it does get it is very entertaining. We probably wouldn't finish it today, but we'd still be able to play it. Zusi, did you finish High on Life yet? How many hours does it take to beat?
Script. Make sure your community has the acceptable answer script to my stupid questions. I don't actually care where you've been. Like, just tell me one of these two canned responses. Like, this is so fucking dumb. And I also love the audacity. Let me give you a lesson here on how to handle my questions going forward. It's just so laughable that he's acting like some kind of social savant here about how to handle public conversations and what you're allowed to say. You're a fucking Twitch streamer, man. All of us as streamers are not exactly the most socially gifted. Like, let's just face the facts here. So why are you trying to act like...
Do you think anyone doesn't like Charlie? That's not like a creator. Like, yes, yeah, Sneeko hates Charlie. Like, I've never seen anyone bitch about Charlie. Like, people hate me, right?
Like, a lot of people are like, oh, my content sucks. But, like, do a lot of people dislike Charlie? Like, I don't know anybody that would not like him. Because he's, like, genuinely just a great creator.
The authority on the matter here, as if you're some kind of social guru.
I feel like he's just too known. There probably are people that don't like him. They probably just don't voice it.
Who's now giving a lecture to your community about what is and is not allowed in a public conversation. It's fucking goofy. It's very silly.
How are you? Good? Or, you know what? I'll make it through. Awesome. Love to hear it. See, there you go.
What do you think he streams? What is his Twitch stream name? Let's do a little evaluation here. What games do you think he plays? Rust, old Call of Duties, like MW2, Genshin? Nah, he doesn't play Genshin. COD, probably like a Battle Royale-esque streamer. Yeah, like a gun shooting, MLB The Show. MLB The Show. The one kid that's streaming MLB The Show. The Big Boy from 300 Bits says, love your bits. Thank you. And the Big Boy from 300 Bits again says, what was your favorite childhood book? I really liked reading the Hunger Games books. But if you're talking like childhood, then like Diary of a Wimpy Kid was pretty chill. Samurai for the sub pop from 300 Bits. Test the new PC on Val, see how smooth it is. High on Life can wait till next week. Yeah, but High on Life just came out. It's kind of hype, you know what I mean? Seki from 300 Bits. Newest to Twitch, how does modding work and VIP work, if you don't mind me asking? Mods have, like, reign over chat. They ban people, time people out, shit like that. VIPs just have a diamond next to their name, and they are removed from chat restrictions. They don't have time delay. They could say more words other chatters can't, etc. They're kind of like a trusted chatter.
Or Prom's response.
That's why 2inch lost it for a bit. But, you know, 2inch was a VIP, so he kind of is in contention to getting it back.
I said, Prom, how are you doing? She says,
CSGO. Does anybody know this guy's Twitch name? I want to see what he streams.
Alive.
You know what's just as easy as those two responses is you being able to respond with some level of empathy like, oh, man, that's terrible. I'm sorry to hear that. Or, damn, that's awful news. Stay strong. Or, man.
Yeah, all he had to do. Dude, all he had to do. Damn, I'm sorry to hear that, bro. I hope you get through it. All he had to do. Like, that means he genuinely got upset. He genuinely got upset that they said their mom died. Like, all he had to do, bro. Yeah, I'm sorry to hear that. I'm sorry to hear that. That's really sad. I'm sorry to hear that your mom died. Don't be a dick. We found the body is his name. No way that's his fucking name. I don't know if he would have gotten... Oh my god, he's a musician. He's a musician. Bro got a fucking 10-minute starting screen. I fucking hate when streamers do that shit. Oh my god, just go live. I just go live when I'm... Yo, y'all ask why I'm late? Because I don't do this shit, right? I'm not going to go live at 4:30 and then have a loading screen for 10 minutes while I set up. My starting screen is 2 minutes. That's not bad. This shit, bro, 12 minutes? 13 minutes? Holy shit, I've seen streamers that have 20-minute starting screens. That's absurd. Zeusy's makes sense because he's waiting for the noti, right? That's fine. Zeusy's just waiting for the notification to come out. That's a two-minute lag time. That's normal. But like fucking 15 minutes, bro. Oh my god. Bro, people just sitting there. Bobat from the 300 Bits. All people mentioning that it was parasocial that she mentioned that. It's not parasocial. Parasocial is like, hey, Joe, I love you, man. Like, I'm so, oh my god, I love you so much. I just see, like, your content just, it's not like your if they say I love your content, hey, Joe, I love you so much. I've been going through a lot. Like, I really wish you could just, like, respond to me. You know what I mean? Like, I really hope I can meet you one day. It's just, oh, I love you so much. That's parasocial. DMing a content creator every day for fucking 3 months is parasocial. Hey, can you respond? Oh my god, I know you're in New Jersey. Can we hang out? Parasocial. Right? No. I don't know you. No. I don't know who the fuck you are. I don't know who you are. I'm gonna hang out with you. Who are you? That's parasocial. Saying your mom died isn't parasocial. Garlic for the 300 bets. Would you ever consider playing The Fridge is Red? What the fuck is that about? Is that a scary game? All he had to say was, I'm sorry for your loss. Dude, literally, that's what I'm saying. All he had to do, it's not even he has to be overtly sincere. Bro, just have to say, yeah, I'm sorry for your loss. And then the Popsosa said, test a new PC on Val. I will. Yo, chat, guess how much FPS I get on Val on the new PC. Just guess. Just guess. Just give it a gander, right? Old PC, off stream, 280 FPS. On stream, 90. New PC, off stream, and hear this out. 500 to 1,000 FPS. On stream, like 350 to 650. That shit's nuts. That shit's fucking nuts. That shit's fucking nuts, dude. My old CPU, when I would stream, would take up 38% of my CPU usage. I'm streaming right now. It's only taking up 16. It takes up half of what my other one did. And I upped my settings too, so I'm actually using more CPU usage. Oh shit, I'm like, what the fuck am I doing? I'm watching this man's loading.
The numbers are numbers. I mean, the follows are coming in. They're coming. I'm coming. We're all coming. Everyone's coming at the same time. It's a group coming together. All right, let me drink my breakfast cum, then we're gonna get into this shit. Oh my god, it's so fucking thick. All right, that's done.
Bro, he just talks.
Yo, Shade's here, fuck yes. Shade, what's up? Gargle it, not gonna happen. All right, so you guys know it's in subs only mode, it's in slow mode, but for anyone lurking that isn't subbed, thank you guys for being here. Let's just start this off. I want to say to you guys that people close to me, people like my family, my friends, people that I've been close with on Twitch for a long time, are really worried about me right now. They're really worried about how this is affecting me mentally.
It's Twitch drama. It's just Twitch drama. His beard is dope. He does have a very nice beard. It's not like, I don't think. Like, dude, yeah, he's gonna get some hate for this. It's not gonna kill his streaming career. Like, dude, Twitch drama like that, like, he might get some hate, lose some viewers. People are still gonna fucking watch him. Like, it's just, like, I don't know what he means affecting him mentally. Like, he might be getting and hate or the threats or some shit, but, like, I doubt it to the extent
you
that
cunt.
It might be. I don't think it would be that bad. Pineapple for the sub. I'm Bradford for the sub. Do you think he's getting a lot of hate? I don't know how big it is on Twitter is what I'm saying. Like, Charlie made a video on it, but, like, I don't know how much people are actually hating on him. Is kind of the thing.
That I haven't addressed. And I've seen guys that's very active in chat, but holy fuck, you definitely support the content.
Okay, whatever. I'm going back to the video. Garlic for the 300 bets. He is Pog in the title? What do you mean?
Shit, that's terrible. Hopefully,
you were my second most watched streamer this year. Dub.
Today's stream can lift your spirits a bit. Like, you also have equally easy responses.
Yo, I'm gonna keep it real with y'all. You know how I said I was gonna shit myself on stream one day? That close. That close. Maybe 30 seconds ago? That close. That close, man. Almost. Didn't. I'm here. I'm good. Almost did. Almost did just now.
To like,
you know, what it's a questionable fart. Yo, I ripped that shit. I don't give a fuck. Y'all can say, oh my god, TMI, that's disgusting. No, I ripped that shit. Questionable.
Kind of dwell on the negative here and for some reason try and shame her for answering your question. Honestly, you could have just as easily,
when I the day I do shit myself on stream, I'm literally just gonna play a sign out music. This is what I'm going to do. Day I shit myself on stream. Because it will happen. See you guys later. That's what I'm going to say. I'm going to say shit my pants. See you guys later. Because I'm not, what do you think? I'm going to take a fucking 30-minute break, go wipe my ass or some shit? Yeah, no. That ruined my day if I shit my pants there. No. Another angel for the $25 dono. Says Merry Christmas, big man, even though I don't celebrate it. I won't be here next few streams. Sorry. You don't have to apologize. You can come to stream whenever you want. You do not have to be here. It is not a requirement, but I appreciate you for being here, and I appreciate the $25 dono. Thank you. And I will see you the next stream. And even though you're not going to be here next few streams, that's fine. I'm not even going to be live Saturday and Sunday. I'm going to be live Friday. That's why we're doing reacts today. I'm going to be doing reacts and High on Life after we're done the reacts. Friday is going to be the cookie and milk tier list. I will be dressed as Santa tomorrow, by the way. That'll be very fun. Saturday and Sunday, I won't be live. Monday, I'll be doing Minecraft, maybe finishing High on Life. Tuesday, I will be doing... Tuesday, I'll be doing probably Reacts and Fortnite or Reacts and Val. Wednesday will be Little Hope. Thursday will be Fortnite and Val. So we will be doing... Even though I'm not playing Fortnite or Val today, probably, I will be playing it a bunch next week. So don't be worried about that. Zero for the sub. When's Val? I don't know. I'll redo the poll here. I'll redo the poll here while we watch the video. Which do we play after Reacts? High on Life. Val. Fort. Vote. I'd be down to do Val if people want me to do Val instead. We could finish High on Life another day. I'm probably not even going to finish High on Life today. It's just a very funny game. You know what I mean? Transitioning from funny reacts to a funny game kind of makes more sense. You know what I mean? We want to veto chat so we could see your FPS. Dude, I could just go into a game. Do you guys want to see my Val FPS? I could literally just go into a Val game and show you in fucking 10 seconds.
We had a very simple and empathetic response to it and moved on from it.
All right, I'm done watching this video, by the way. I already said everything I want to say about that shit. All right. Do you guys want to watch these? These are the predictions. These are kids from the 60s trying to predict the future. And then we have a video on where everybody went wrong and right. I do think it's fascinating to see how wrong people are. People from the 60s saying that in 2020 we're going to have flying cars, jetpacks, we're all going to be immortal, shit like that.
Well, in the year 2000, I think I'll probably be the spaceship to the moon dictating robots, or else I may be, I don't know, in charge of a robot court, judging some robots.
Yeah, everybody says robots. Bro probably works at a fucking Wendy's. We got regular shit. Hey, we got VR. Hey, we got VR, though. We got the metaverse. That's the future. That's the future, everybody. We got the metaverse.
Or I may be at a funeral of a computer. Or if something's gone wrong with their nuclear bombs, I may be sort of coming back from hunting in a cave.
I don't like the idea of sort of getting out and finding you've got...
Speak up! I can't fucking hear ya!
Cabbage pill to eat for breakfast or something.
Oh, I think all these atomic bombs will be dropping around the place. And one will get near the centre because it will sort of make a huge, great big crater. And then the world will just melt and the world will become one vast atomic explosion.
Damn, this kid got a fucking pessimistic view of the world. Bro just said all the nuclear bombs are gonna go off and the world's gonna melt. Holy shit. Maybe have a little more optimism here. Oh my god, everybody says I'm fucking sad. This kid's just saying the world's gonna die.
And it will become like a supernova, stars.
Some madman will get the atomic bomb. And,
oh my god, are all they gonna fucking talk about is a bomb, dude? Yeah, let's go to the next video. Yeah, fuck that. They're all just gonna talk about bombs. Because it was 1960. 1989 thought houses would look like this in 2020.
What are going to be the biggest changes in our homes by 2020? Will the house of the future protect the environment? And what new technology do researchers think we'll be living with? Well, we've been talking to some of the people who've been thinking about the home of the future. Christine McNulty.
You know what I think about every day? You know what I think about every day? Every fucking day, dude. We're almost here. We're almost at Nuketown 2025. I know this is a COD talk right now. We are. BO2, we're almost, bro, we're actually like 2 years, not even three. It's almost 2023. We are so close to Nuketown 2025. Holy shit. Fucking hell. I mean, I know it looks old-fashioned there, but still. Like, bro, but I remember just reading that. Fucking when BO2 came out, I was like, oh, 2025. Now we're there. Nothing happened.
I started the Home of the Future project to find out what people will want from their homes. They'll want all the benefits of modern technology, but without all this cluttered and complex gadgetry that we have today. They'll want homes that work for them. By 2020, all of this will be possible. We'll have things under control without all of these knobs and buttons. And what's more, the technology itself will be embedded in the very fabric of the house and its furnishings.
So the idea is, once all the clutter of technology has gone, you'll be able to furnish your rooms in any style you like. You won't actually be able
to... What a dumbass house! You see how stupid this fucking house looks? Why do they got so many fucking stairs?
You'll be able to furnish your rooms in...
Look at a Christmas tree in the corner.
Any style you like. You won't actually be able to see the technology, but it will be there, doing its job without getting in your way.
That means the lights automatically switch off and on as you walk between rooms. And the home...
Is that a thing? Lights turn on and off as we walk through rooms. No.
Learns how bright you like them.
I mean, maybe a really rich house like Bill Gates' house might have that. We ain't got that. Motion sensors, yeah.
Simple command gives you music, perhaps piped in from a sound library. Bark, please. And no more PowerPoints.
Yo, they're kind of getting that shit right, though. They got the fucking Alexa shit. They got Alexa. Damn!
Plugs become pads, picking up power from anywhere on the wall.
That's stupid as shit. Anywhere in the wall? Anywhere in the wall. I just slap some shit on the side of the wall. I can fucking blow dry my hair in my living room. That's not even a need. That's just like, we could have made that. Yeah, why?
And even windows will take an active part in the home, according to another researcher, David Button.
This is today's glass technology, whereby combining thin transparent coatings with ordinary conventional glass, we're able to change the performance of the glass. We can diffuse the glass for privacy, and with other coatings, we can control the glare and the solar radiation. In other words, we can vary...
Solar radiation? What, are you worried about the sun hitting your skin?
The performance of the window. This liquid crystal display TV again involves a material sandwiched between two thin pieces of glass. Screens more than a meter wide are being developed. These systems depend on light passing through the glass. But this glass has a coating which can act as a light source in itself, becoming a prototype display screen. This imaging technology...
What the fuck is David Button talking about right now? Y'all understand any of the shit this man is saying?
...embodied in very thin coatings, which will be developed to be transparent. And when combined with ordinary glass, it means that your glass tabletop could become a VDU screen. And indeed...
Bro said our glass tape... Yes, a glass tabletop could become a video screen. That is a thing. A touchpad. Like a fucking big-ass iPad as your table. Yeah. Now, bro, why didn't he just say that? Bro got all these dumbass wires and shit to try and explain that. I'll be able to call people on my table. Yeah.
Your window could become something very remarkable.
See, like, these are technologies that are available, yeah, in 2022, but, like, so little people have them. Like, how many people have that shit?
So a simple command could turn a window into a wall. And you could decorate it how you want.
Dude, that already existed in 1989. Like, the fucking one-way window, one-way screen, mirrors, what?
Or it could be a television or a computer screen. Well, that may be a little futuristic or too expensive for most people. But there's one area where homes are going to have to change.
There will have been enormous pressure on us to cut down on our burning of fossil fuels to protect the environment. This means that energy management in our homes will become of critical importance. There are already materials that can help.
Yeah, no, I don't think anybody gives a. I don't think we've improved on this.
This honeycomb material is being.
It is an issue. Yeah, no, it was an issue then too. I think that's why they're saying, oh yeah, we're gonna fix it by now. We ain't fixed shit.
On the outside of a building in Strathclyde to heat it by trapping the energy in diffuse daylight as it hits the walls. And aerogel, this is aerogel here, is a form of glass with a similar structure at a microscopic level. It can do the same job, but it'll be thinner and transparent. And if these two things become widely used by 2020, the coatings could one day reduce heating bills almost to zero and help to cut down our use of fossil.
Yeah, no one uses that. All right, that is... This is dead wrong. I see, like, yeah, they got a few things right. This is dead fucking wrong, though. Smart heating.
Home to use more energy more intelligently. The heating system could learn your daily routine and only heat the rooms that you'll be using. The living
aerogel
room...
Aerogel breaks with the slightest touch? Yeah, I don't know why the fuck... I feel like that was just inefficient to use. She was holding it so carefully.
...would be at just the right temperature as you come downstairs.
The people who are already planning the home we'll be living in 30 years assure us that we can take as much or as little of this technology as we like. The crucial point is that there'll be no single home of the future, there'll be millions of different ones. We choose the type of home we want to live in, the technology takes a back seat. BBC One, please.
What? Did she just say there was fucking a million different homes we would be able to choose from? All right, this video is probably going to be the better one. This is the last video we're doing, then we're going to go to the gaming. Skate for the sub, airplane for the sub, to big boy for the 300 bets. 100% high on life. Yo, mods, can you run one more poll for that to see what video game we're doing? IHOH for the 300 bets. Been lefted for a year. I turned 14 a month ago. Squat 225. Deadlift 285 and bench 165. Is that good? Yeah, generally, it just kind of depends on, like, your height and weight in comparison to that. But yeah, for being 14, that's about where my shit was. Kind of nearing that fucking end of my freshman year. That's about what I was doing. Maybe a little bit more on the deadlift, but squat was the same. Bench was probably the same. I've been following you on TikTok since 40K. Really? I find that hard to believe. Wait for the sub. All right, hold up. I'm going to go take a piss real quick. Then we will be back. Musashi for the sub. We'll play some funk music. All right, hold up. Actually, I'll play a different song for y'all. I'm about to put y'all on. All right, count me down 30 seconds. I gotta run to the bathroom. I'm the Wonder Woman, let me go get my robe. I'm a supermodel and mommy, see mommy. Amnesty International got Bangkok to Montauk on lock. Love my ass and my abs in the video for promiscuous. My style is ridiculous. If you see us in the club, we'll be acting real nice. If you see us on the floor, you'll be watching all night. We ain't here to hurt nobody. Give it to me, give it to me, give it to me. Wanna see you work your body. Give it to me, give it to me, give it to me. My God. Y'all see that trend on TikTok with that song? Good as shit. Good as shit. Do a poll with just Valorant and High on Life. Yeah, do a poll with just Val and High on Life because Fortnite's losing every single time. We'll still play Fortnite. I still really want to play the Fortnite new chapter, but I doubt we're going to be playing that today. So poll that. Musashi for the sub. Hold up. Yes, the Zoolander. Well, it's not actually in Zoolander, I don't think.
Possible by Dashlane.
What past predictions of the future got right?
Secure your data from prying eyes by signing up for a free account.
For almost the entirety of human history, we've always had a bit of a thing for predicting the future. Sometimes we get pretty close, and sometimes we're way off. In this episode, we're going to look at a few of the notable examples since the early 20th century, when we really began to wonder how modern and future technology would change our lives and the world. We'll start with one topic that people still love to theorize about today, the future of cars. Back in the late 30s...
Yo, bro, figure it out. Figure it out. Bravo, you got your little screen time, bro. Figure it out, dude. What are you fucking doing? Get out of my chat. Oh my god, what the fuck?
In the 30s and 40s, cars had officially become a staple of modern society. And as a relatively new technology, people were always thinking...
Donnie for the 300 bits. The Simpsons are more accurate. The Simpsons predict the future just because they make so many fucking episodes.
...up new ways to make them even better. In the 1930s, the predictions for the future of cars were pretty tame. Not many dreams of flying cars yet.
The development of more complete streamlining for motor cars will be the problem of engineers of tomorrow. Someday, this problem will...
Yo, this shit's boring as hell. Can we skip this? Can we skip this? We'll watch a scary video instead. Y'all want to watch a scary video instead? Yo, that was an L video. That was an L vid. This shit's boring as fuck. I'm gonna keep it real. I wanna entertain y'all, and I know that video sucks, but I think it's boring. Cause y'all get bored. Y'all will get bored faster than I do. So if I'm bored, I know y'all are bored. Fuck that video. I'm skipping that shit. We're gonna watch one scary video, then we'll go into the fucking gaming and shit. Cause I don't want to end on a shitty react. What's a good scary vid? What's a good short scary video? Like a five to 8 minute scary video. That's very specific. Colin for the 300 bits. When I was 7, my parents took me to see 2012. I thought it was real and I was dead scared. Avery for the sub. Fishy for the 300 bits. High on Life 1 3 times, about to be 4. Don't do a 5th. Dude, I'm just seeing how it compares. Yeah, High on Life 1. We're going to do High on Life. I'm saying I want to do another react real quick. What's a scary vid? Unlucky Charms. Already watched that. But y'all recommend the videos that I've already seen. I got good ass scary videos queued up for like near Christmas, like a few days before Christmas when we do React Day. But I want to save those. And they're longer too. They're like 20 minutes. My Little Pony is scary. Do they have a scary video about My Little Pony? Horror. Shed.mo. The fuck is this? Oh, I'm joking? What is this, though?
God, now that I've won this, I finally like myself.
Yo, this is gonna be so totally fucking rad.
Alright, give me another video. That video sucks. What the fuck was that? But I was actually watching it. Because what the fuck is that? I didn't even know what the hell that is. Russian sleep experiment. But I'm about to look up scary short story. Because y'all just recommended ones that I've already seen. A bus stop horror story? Yo, we'll watch that. Hold up. I'll turn off one of the lights for this shit, too. Pop for the 3. You said you do Mr. Ballin video? Yeah, but his videos are like 30 minutes long. I'll do one of them soon. I do have Mr. Ballin videos queued. And one of them, he actually did a Christmas one, I think I'm going to watch. But his videos are long as hell. I'm not trying to watch a long-ass one right now. 9-inch for the sub. A bus stop horror story animated.
This happened when I was 17 years old. I would go to the gym.
Thank for the sub.
3 to 4 times a week and ride the bus home. It was a Sunday and I had just missed my bus, so I had to wait longer for another one. I would have called my parents, but they were out for the evening, and taxis charged more, so I decided to sit and wait in the bus shelter. It was a cold night, and snow had just started peppering the ground.
Yo, Manifest, you don't need to type your message 3 times every time you type a message. Just a quick PSA, you know? When you type a message, you can type it 1 time, right? You don't need to type the message 3 times every time, right? You could just type it once, right? Thank for the sub.
My bus was taking longer than usual, so I got my phone out and listened to some music. Almost an hour had passed. It was freezing and I hadn't seen anyone at all. That was until I noticed something out of the corner of my eye. It was a creepy guy dressed in thick layers of clothing, walking slowly towards me. I knew staring at him would draw more attention, so I just focused on my phone. He sat down at the other end of the shelter and just stared at me.
Bitch! I'm getting up! I'm at a bus stop in the middle of the night, this man is fucking staring me the fuck down, I'm out.
There was something off about him. He seemed like he was either drunk or on drugs. He then asked,
"What does the bus do?"
I took out my earphone.
Did he just say, "What does the bus do?"
And said,
"I think it's delayed."
Is the bus due? I was gonna say, "What does the bus do?" Bitch, are you asking me how mechanically a bus works? It takes people places. Bryn, for the 300 bets. Me and my brother used to watch My Little Pony that you just watched. You watch that shit? 9-inch Barty for the 5 gifted subs. Thank you, 9-inch Barty, for the 5 gifteds. Dub in the chat for that. Thank you for the fucking gifted subs.
Of the snow.
He stared at me for a while, then started mumbling to himself. He was really starting to creep me out, so I pretended to be on my phone. After a couple of minutes, I took another look. He moved closer to me. I looked away for a second.
He starts inching. He starts doing one of these. He starts doing... Yo! I'd say, what are you trying to cuddle or some shit, you fucking wacko? Get the fuck on the other side of the bench, bitch. Oh my god. Bro, that shit's fucking whack. I'm gonna say, get the fuck out of here. You trying to get near me? You smell bad. You're that dude that smells like shit. Yeah, from earlier in this fucking stream. You're that kid that smelled like shit in fucking middle school. Get the fuck out of here.
And then heard the sound of him sliding even closer. I turned to him and said,
"You okay there?"
He stared at me with glossy eyes, lifted his arm and leaned towards
me. He starts leaning in for a kiss. Oh, nah.
Me. Immediately, I grabbed my bag and ran as he fell to the ground. I ran down the road, trying my hardest not to look back. I kept going until I got to the next bus stop. I turned around to check.
He sits down at the next bus stop. The other guy shows up 5 minutes later and sits back down and just starts doing this again. The fucking inching thing. It's just like a never-ending process.
See if he was there. He was gone, so I went to sit down. Feeling relieved, I rested my head on the back of the glass and waited for the bus.
Bro, is that it?
I jolted and turned around to see the same guy staring at me through the glass.
What the hell is wrong with you?
Then he started walking around the shelter towards me.
Nah, I'm gonna pull one of those things where I run around the table. I'm not letting him get on the fucking same side I am.
I'm warning you, stay back.
I yelled in panic as I was backing up. I wanted to run, but I left my bag in the shelter and I couldn't leave without it. Suddenly, the man leaped at me and I quickly moved out of the way. He fell to the ground face first.
I kick him in the face.
I froze in shock, then noticed the blood coming from his face.
Bro, I'd be worried they would try and say I killed him. No! Oh my god, does he just die? Does he just die?
I tried to get a response out of him, but nothing worked. I called the police and paramedics.
How did bro fall that hard? That he just starts gushing blood.
And they arrived shortly after. I told them what had happened, and they told me that the guy was on prescription drugs.
Oh.
They found a photo in his wallet of him and his son. The boy looked just like me, so we assumed he thought I was him. I later learned that he had lost his son in a custody battle and went off the rails. He was taken away for treatment, and that was the last I saw of him.
Ooh.
I got my driver's license shortly after. And have never been on a bus since.
What the fuck was that?
Never been on a bus since.
That's a little quick addition there. A little scary additive. All right, that was a good video. 9-inch for the 300 bets. All right, hold on. You guys, I'll satisfy both people right now. Or both people. We're going to be doing High on Life. That was a W React stream. I'm going to show you guys my Valor in FPS real quick. Do y'all want to see my Val FPS?
before we go to High on Life. Just a quick flex on the PC speeds.